into the day with the dawn ringing in my ears. Oh, well, I tune into my TV show. No better way, I gotta get myself into gear. Let's go. Good morning, you beautiful souls. Welcome to it. Yes, it is Friday. Good morning, my friend.
Good morning, G-Man.
Welcome to it.
Yes, and we're super excited because today's show, I feel like every day we tell you it's a jam-packed show, but today really is jam-packed. It's one you do not want to miss because the golden boy of the Springboks team, Willie LaRue, has recently tied the knot with Holly, and we have the newlyweds in studio after their honeymoon, and we are going to have a bit of an exclusive sit-down and talk with them.
I love it. And we've got a lot of emotional investment here from all angles, whether it's coming from the wedding side, whether it's coming from the rugby side, or just the human side. We've got two incredible human beings joining us this morning, so we cannot wait for that. And then we're going to get deep as we get to know the ins and outs of the beautiful couple, along with some of the fun that they have had and that they will have on this show. And maybe we'll throw them into the kitchen as well.
I'm looking forward to it. And then what is a Friday without a Friday dance? I think it's only fitting that G-Man, how's your rhythm? How's your gum
rhythm? Well, I think
rhythm?
We've proven this on the show, yeah?
Oh, well, he's going to be put head to head and getting a bit of a gumboot dance lesson from the Imibala gumboot dancers. So we are looking forward to that. Have you started warming up?
Every day is a warm up when you've got young children. Luckily, we get used to these things. I cannot wait to embrace that, embrace the weekend, embrace everything about this Friday. And of course, you have a front row seat, and we are connecting right now to Johannesburg with the fun is going to continue. Good morning, Sanele.
Good morning, Cape Town. Can you see how excited I am that the weekend is here? We're singing, baby. Coming to you live from the Samsung showroom at Design Quarter in Johannesburg. And it is about to be a beautiful weekend because we are going to start it off together, Espresso family. But more than anything else, we always make sure that you have a delicious helping to get you through the morning and to make sure that you start it off in the best shape. Now, speaking of shape, I have been actually just making sure that I'm in the best shape myself because we have got sports royalty in the building. The beautiful Zoe told you about Willie LaRue, who is here with his gorgeous wife. And I am so excited about it because honestly, what would we be without those people? Do you know what I mean? As a country, we're world champions, you feel me? But I also know that you am dying to ask them a question. And so are you. So you got to come through in terms of our beautiful WhatsApp line, 063-408-8863, as well as on the social media streets, hashtag Espresso Show. We want to know what is that one question that you have got for Willie LaRue and his beautiful wife this morning right here on Espresso. And when we say that, it can be anything in the world. I know for me, I need to ask them about Paris. How did they survive each and every week? Week in, week out, there was only one point separating us and the opponents. What were they doing? How did they get through? And it can be answered right here on your Feel Good Breakfast show. So do the right thing, hashtag Espresso Show, and send us a voice note on 063-408-8863. Right about now, though, we need to start off the morning the right way, and that's by making sure that you and us are informed, and that's why Zoe is standing by with the news.
Thank you, Zanele. Well, listen, those are all valid questions, and hopefully we'll get all those answers for you. It's 6 a.m. Let's take a first look at your headlines, starting off with national news. President Cyril Ramaphosa has urged male traditional leaders to open dialogues with other men to help stop gender-based violence. He was speaking at the opening of the National House of Traditional and Khoisan Leaders in Cape Town yesterday. Ramaphosa called on male traditional leaders to be part of this effort and to start their own men's dialogues. He said dialogue had shown to be effective in ending the abuse of women and girls. GBV continues to tear communities apart, he said. And the Minister of Water and Sanitation, Senzo Mkhunu, has committed to fully restoring the water supply in KwaZimba, west of Durban, by the end of April. Addressing a water imbizo in the area, Mkhunu promised that water woes would be soon a thing of the past. The community has been protesting for several days, demanding water. The minister added that they could install a package plant to provide the community with 7 megalitres a day, and more water tankers will be added to the area. And beyond our own borders, Kenya has exempted passport holders from South Africa and six other countries from paying an unpopular entry fee introduced last month. In January, the government scrapped visa requirements for all foreign passport holders to promote the country as a tourist destination and to attract business travellers. In addition to South Africa, Kenya also scrapped visa requirements for Ethiopia, Eritrea, Congo-Brazzaville, the Comoros Islands and Mozambique. Europe's third smallest nation, San Marino, is also the only other country on the exemption list. And the White House coordinator for the Middle East, Brett McGurk, has arrived in Israel as America intensifies efforts to broker an agreement between Israel and Hamas to secure the release of hostages. Israel has warned that it will continue with a ground offensive in Rafah in the south of Gaza if Hamas does not release the remaining hostages by the beginning of Ramadan next month. The death toll since the start of Israel's offensive in October has risen to 29,410. And celebrating its 20th anniversary, George is geared and ready for the Otanikwa Chair Challenge tomorrow, a dual competitive event welcoming not only wheelchairs, but also racing chairs, hand cycles and basketball chairs. Organised by Alvain Dipenaar, the event features categories for quadriplegic and paraplegic athletes and subcategories based on chair type. Additionally, a lively 5-kilometre fun course sees wheelchair competitors paired with enthusiastic helpers. Drawing participants from Namibia, Ghana, Zimbabwe, Nigeria and Botswana, the Otanikwa Chair Challenge 2024 unfolds at the Carpe Diem School in George from today. The official opening is at 6 p.m. and tomorrow kicks off early at 7 a.m., culminating in an award ceremony at lunchtime. Well, that's where I leave your headlines. Let's get a first look at your sport with Graham.
Thank you so much. So let's start it off with football this morning. World Cup winner Toni Kroos has confirmed his return to the German national team. That's ahead of their Euro 2024 campaign, which will, of course, be hosted in Germany. The 34-year-old midfielder who retired after Euros back in 2020 will be available for selection in upcoming friendlies against France and the Netherlands, where they could use his experience. Germany aims to improve its performance following recent struggles, including early exits and, of course, the past two World Cups. And staying with footballing news off the pitch, Spanish head coach Luis de la Fuente has signed a contract extension up until 2026, ensuring his leadership through the next World Cup in the United States, Mexico and Canada. So the Spanish Football Federation stated that this extension provides stability ahead of the European Championship in June. De la Fuente, he took over as coach in 2022 following Spain's early exit from the World Cup in Qatar. Then on to cricket, and fast bowler Ollie Robinson has been included in the English team for the fourth test against India in Ranchi, marking his first match of the series. So the 30-year-old's last appearance for England was in the third Ashes test at Headingley last year. And he comes in to replace Mark Wood, while spinner Shoaib Bashir, he replaces Rehan Ahmed. And after a 434-run defeat in that third test, a record breaker, in fact, England currently trailing 2-1 in that five-match series. Then on to golf. Charlie Woods, the 15-year-old son of Tiger Woods, saw his hopes of qualifying for the PGA Tour event in Palm Beach Gardens dashed after shooting a 16-over par 86 in his pre-qualifying event. Not the best day out. Despite aspirations to make it to the US PGA Tour, the Cognizant Classic, his round at Lost Lake Golf Club, ended to any chance of a tour debut, sadly. So while Woods showed promise early on, a rough patch at the par 4 seventh hole had hindered his progress, and despite his setback, Woods maintained composure and has previously showcased his talent. We know what he is worth alongside his father in exhibition tournaments, so I'm sure we'll see him again pretty soon. Then, of course, we've got the Carabao Cup coming up this weekend, Liverpool up against Chelsea. We're going to delve a little deeper into that in just a moment. But right now, let's get our first toast of the weather.
We start off with some weather news, and the South African Weather Service has issued a yellow level 2 warning, and that's for severe thunderstorms with the possibility of strong damaging winds and large amounts of small hail expected over the southwestern Free State and the southeastern parts of the Northern Cape. Extreme high fire danger conditions are also expected over the interior of the Northern Cape, the northeastern interior of the Western Cape, the north interior of the Eastern Cape, and the central and western parts of the Free State and the southwestern parts of the Northwest and extreme northern parts of Limpopo. Then a heat wave with persistent high temperatures that's expected over the eastern parts of the Northern Cape, in places over the Free State and Northwest until Saturday, but over the extreme northern parts of the Eastern Cape until tomorrow. Well, that's your weather update. Let's take a first look at a sunrise view. Anne from Magaliesberg shared her morning view. Look at that sunrise. If you would like to share yours, in fact, it's Magaliesberg, that view, share it with us on WhatsApp. That number is 063-408-8863. Here's a first look at your temperatures. And brace yourself, 42 degrees Celsius. Woo, that is hot.
Every day this week. It's okay. Rather just stay indoors, certainly for the next 3 hours, because we got you covered. Carabao Cup is coming up this week in Liverpool up against Chelsea. Kurt Buckerfield is going to be joining us to break it down.
Oh, and we want to get to know our artists for today a little bit better. Durban Gogo is in Johannesburg, and Zanele is going to sit down and unpack a little bit more about life.
And the beats will flow. Yep. Yes. Welcome back, you beauties. Time to talk a little footy, and we want to get ready for a football showdown. There's a lot of beef involved in this one as Chelsea and Liverpool gear up to battle for the Carabao Cup final again this weekend at the famed Wembley. And with both teams eyeing their first major trophy of the season with very much different narratives for both teams, anticipation is probably as high as their epic clash in 2022. And here to chat to us is football journalist Kurt Buckfield. Kurt, thank you so much for joining us.
Graham.
Best job in the world, hey? You
love it. Yeah, thank you for having me.
And we love being able to pluck into to big football brains like yours when there is so much going on and so much baggage attached to a match
yes,
like this.
We absolutely. Love it.
We love the kind of rivalry that's represented here. Two right teams for this final. One would feel that Chelsea might have kind of gotten a free pass in here. How are you feeling about the Carabao Cup as the silverware that it represents in the season this year?
Yeah, I think it's hugely significant for both sides right now. I think that Chelsea obviously have an opportunity to win their first trophy under
Pochettino,
which is huge in a season where they haven't played very well. And they've obviously been struck with injuries, issues all over the park. So, yeah, it's a huge game for Chelsea. For Liverpool, it's Jurgen Klopp's final season. Fans will be hoping that this is the start of a dream last 4 months in charge. So a huge game between two top sides, yeah.
There are dreams. They are anchored in some reality when it comes to this Liverpool side. We do believe they can do something special.
Yes,
they've proven
absolutely.
It. They're playing amazingly well. There is an emotional conversation there as well, obviously around Klopp's departure. Could they do it? What, when you have to set aside whatever judgments and look at this team on paper and where they are and the time that's left, could they have the kind of end to the season that people are hoping?
I think so. They can obviously win on Sunday, which would be their first trophy of the season. They could then go on to still win the Premier League. They're very much in a title race. They still are in the Europa League. They're in the FA Cup. So they could end the season with four trophies. It's very, very possible with the way that they've been playing. So, yeah, I wouldn't write that off. Do I think it's going to happen? Probably not, but I think they could end the season really strong with Jurgen Klopp.
You want to say it a little bit louder? So half of my studio can just simmer down, just calm down.
They won't do it.
It's going to be a tough draw. I mean, we know City just have this other gear that they'll find at this time of the year. What is happening at Chelsea? An amazing team, some amazing young stars. It felt like they've invested in young talent.
Yes.
They've helped them emerge on the top platform. They've got Poch. I mean, come on, what hasn't clicked? Can we just say injuries at critical times, or is there more at play?
I think that's a really good point, but then I think there's just an unfamiliarity among the players. They don't really know each other. A lot of them are very young, like you've just pointed out. A lot of them are new. In fact, from this squad that Chelsea have right now, Thiago Silva is the only player who started that 2002 final, and that's 2 years ago.
That's
a lot
crazy.
Of changes in a very, very short time. So, yeah, I think they've obviously had bad luck with injuries, Pochettino's first season, new ownership, a load of problems to deal with. But they could do it. They've been playing against City this past week, and they played really, really well. So that's the kind of confidence they need to take.
Well, I think heartbreaking for the fans is when you get those glimpses of what's actually possible. I think we know Poch is a player's coach.
Yes.
And if anyone can bring a squad together and kind of build a long-term vision, he's certainly the man for that. That being said, how do they counter Liverpool this weekend? What do they need to do to quell that fire that seems to be burning at the moment?
Yeah, it's very difficult to stop Liverpool right now, I think. Look, they've also got some injuries to contend with potentially this weekend. There were questions surrounding fitness over Mohamed Salah and Darwin Nunez.
And?
Jota's out for the rest of the season, I think.
Yeah.
So I think that it'll be very difficult to stop them. Liverpool have goals from all around the park. I think there are five players in that squad with 10 or more
kind
goals
of multiple
this season.
Tallies, yeah.
And Liverpool just became the first club in Europe to score 100 goals this season. So it's very difficult to stop them, and I'm not sure they will, but they certainly have a chance if they can play like they did this last weekend.
Is Salah likely in?
I think he probably will be available. He was rested midweek against Luton. He, of course, came back for the Brentford game this past weekend. But I think the thought right now is that he'll be back. He'll be there.
If he's remotely fit, put him in.
He's
got
to play.
In your heart of hearts, how do you see this one playing out?
I think Liverpool win this 2-1.
2-1.
Yeah.
It's tight. I think some would like a little bit more breathing room in there. I have a feeling Chelsea might do something special with this one. Wherever your allegiances lie, I know we can be a little bit biased sometimes. We got you. Don't worry. Share your thoughts with us. Who's going to take this first major piece of silverware this year? I think Poch needs a little bit more. Maybe Klopp wants it a little bit more. We cannot wait to find out who is going to have bragging rights this season.
Well, maybe you want bragging rights if you win and the lotto. Now, you can set your sights on winning the millions when you play Powerball and Powerball Plus for 66 million rand in total estimated jackpots today. Just imagine the endless possibilities of how you will spend that money. Now, you can play Powerball for an estimated 40 million rand and Powerball Plus for an estimated 26 million rand, but there's only one way of standing a chance to win the millions, and that is if you play. Now, you can buy your tickets today in store. You can buy them on the nationallottery.co.za's website. You can also buy your tickets on the mobile app through cell phone banking or simply by dialing *120*7529# for USSD. And don't worry, we have all of those details on Expresso's social media pages, so go and check them out and make sure to get your tickets. A life-changing 66 million rand in total estimated Powerball and Powerball Plus jackpots are waiting to be won. Will it be you? Well, you've got a Panda Pusher Play to find out. We are taking the quickest of breaks on your Feel Good Breakfast show. We're going to get to know our artist today, Durban Gogo. And then we've got a bit of a game we want you to get involved in, so stay tuned.
It's my feel-good breakfast show. Very sneaky.
on your Feel Good Breakfast Show right here on S3. And as I always tell you, it is the only way to get your morning started off, my love. And thank you for allowing us to, okay? Because we always have only the best in studio. And this is why, as we come to you live from the Samsung showroom in Design Quarter in Johannesburg, we have got a woman of note, someone who honestly and truly just continues to push the margin. I am talking about a name taker. She is a record breaker. She is someone who is what I call the leader of pop culture in South Africa, and hailing from Durban, but growing up in Pretoria and going on to do things like have a viral hit song that won an Amapiano Award. I am talking about someone who is just the personification of greatness. Everybody, please welcome to Espresso Durban Gogo! Come on! Hello.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm fine. How are you?
Oh, good. Thank you. Thank you for waking up for us.
Thank you for having me.
Of course. We're going to get to you and clickbait in a little bit, right? Yes. But first, I want us to start where things kind of took off officially for you, which was Khuza Gogo, ne?
Yeah.
This was a song that went viral. Everyone was listening to it. Everyone knew it in South A. Yeah. Was it a track that you knew was going to go viral?
You know, actually, no. I actually didn't think it was going to, because it was released, and obviously, from the first time it sort of became known, mm-hmm. it now went into a different version when Pura jumped onto it.
Sure.
And then after the fact, then there was the dance challenge, and then that's when it like blew up. But I think it was something special either way. It was like my first solo single. So yeah.
I just got goosebumps about you talking about it, because I remember when you did your very first gig for homecoming events. Yeah. And I remember that specific video that one of the MDs actually took of you arriving and getting ready for your set. Yeah. And the sun was still in the sky. Now you are the headliner. I want to know, Durban Gogo, how long did it take for you to break into the industry?
You know what? I've been DJing, what, 8 years now?
Sure.
I would say breakthrough probably happened around lockdown. Yeah, lockdown was the real breakthrough for me. So 4 or 5 years.
What do you think made the difference in terms of that?
Everyone was just more focused, more like trying to figure out like what are they gonna do to entertain themselves while we're at home.
Yes.
I think during lockdown, piano was working harder than any other genre.
That's true.
We were dropping all the time. We were doing live mixes and partying, you know, the incognito partying.
Durban Gogo, don't get us into trouble, please.
Yeah, so people were watching us move and shake, and they were like, what is this thing? What is the sound?
Sure. You
know? So, yeah.
I actually love that. I never knew that that was the case in terms of how you saw it. You know what I mean? Yeah. In terms of what Amapiano's been doing. But yeah, one of the biggest moves that you've made, not just DJing, going on to now produce. That was quite the decision to make, because I feel like that's not easy. Yeah?
No, it's not easy, but I think when you're DJing, at a certain point, you hit a plateau.
Yeah.
You know, you can only play other people's music
for so long.
Yeah, so you have to always figure out what is the next move, what's the next thing.
Yes.
And how can you elevate your talent? And yeah, next step in your career.
Definitely. And babes, you've blown up even more because of it. I want to know, what's been the biggest highlight in terms of you deciding to produce?
The biggest highlight?
Was it working with a specific person? Was it a specific song? Did you surprise yourself with the skills? What was it?
Actually, I think one of my biggest highlights is still possible. Because I had an idea in my head, but I didn't know exactly how to execute it.
Yeah.
And I had a session with Musa that day.
Yeah.
But I had invited a bunch of other people. You know, at that time, I didn't realize, like, actually, not everyone is going to do something on a song. But I was like, you know, I wanted keys that sounded like Afrotech progression.
Yeah.
So I called Lebs of the Villain. I'm like, you know, I want something that sounds like this. And that's when he did the gong, 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 gong.
Come on.
And yeah, then the idea came together and we were like, okay, are we adding more lyrics? Are we leaving it like this? And then we played it and then it started to go viral and then we just left it as is.
It's just you say going viral like it's anything. Like, oh, I'm just going to the bathroom. I'm just going viral. It's who I am. Durban Gogo, but this is why we love you, because you're just so used to excellence. And one of the pieces of excellence that you've given us most recently is Clickbait. Speak to us about it. How has that journey been?
Oh, Clickbait, my little labor of love.
Yeah.
It's been really crazy, actually, because obviously when you listen to it, it's not your typical piano. It's got a little bit of three-step, it's got some Afro house, it's got some chrome, and obviously your piano log drums.
Yeah.
So I just wanted to do something different and also incorporate all the genres in SA that are finally getting the spotlight again or re-entering our market as well, and giving it that attention and just showing the versatility of myself and even just us as creators in SA.
Yeah.
So yeah, I love it. It's such a good EP.
It's so good. Madam President of Amapianoville, you are killing it. And of course, you know, Uthando is something that is so special at the moment, even with you guys releasing the music video. Beautiful. I want to know, why did you choose that specific song as the lead single?
I loved Uthando because it didn't sound the way that it does now. Mm. Atmos really came in with, you know, just putting it all together. He was sort of the glue. Him and Yams were sort of the glue.
Yeah.
And I just remember Dr. Tools, when you first came into studio, singing this, like, and it was just like so beautiful. And I'm like, you know, let's get back to singing about love.
Yeah. Because
things are always so dreary. We're dancing,
that's
we're drinking.
True.
Like,
yes.
Let's go back to the basics. And I'm like, you know, it's my first proper like love song. So I was like, let me show the softer side of myself.
Girl, and we love it. We love you. We love Uthando. And you know, we love. Did you hear that? Okay,
girl.
Just in case for your next EP. Thank you. Thanks. Devin Gogo.
I got your number.
Thank you. Thank you. You're not going anywhere because you're about to blow us away with Uthando. But Espresso family, this is why you got to stick around, because Devin Gogo is going to be doing the things that need to be done for a Friday to officially be on its way, my love. For now, though, we are crossing back to Cape Town because Zoe is standing by in the lounge.
Oh, thanks, Anelia. We are so excited for the Friday. And in fact, we're going to kick it off early because it's time to break free in another round of the Be Free game. Now, this is how it's going to work. I have two contestants. They were talking sports earlier. We have Carl and Graham. They are ready to, Kurt and Graham, to play. You see, I just want to change.
They
couldn't be.
The case. I'm right. Sorry.
Look, she calls everyone Carl from time to time, and I've just learned to accept
honestly, it's
that
a safe bet.
Yeah, exactly.
Go with Carl.
Mr. Wasty, in honour of you, sir, you're always present in our studio.
We're going to put the two gents head to head to play this game. Now, how it's going to work is I'm going to ask them a series of rapid-fire questions, which will give them the freedom to imagine what they would do or choose, and they need to tell me that the first thing that comes to mind. So it is all about the quick answers. The winner will be determined as the person who gives the best and most honest answers. So are we ready to play?
Yes, let's go.
With trepidation, I say yes.
Well, gents, you have got a delicious snack. You've got your lactose-free, no-lactose snack. Are you ready? We've got some strawberry yogurt there. We've got our granola, some fresh fruit. It's all about being lactose-free.
I'm ready.
Are we ready? Are we ready? Okay. So first up, in fact, Kurt, I think I'm going to start off with you.
Cool.
Round one.
Good luck.
You're free to have any artistic talent you wish.
Singing. Yeah. Is that an artistic talent?
Yes.
Oh, for sure.
I would love to be able to sing, yeah, for sure.
G-Man.
Huge.
You're free to conquer one of your fears.
Wow. diving, like in water, diving.
Okay.
I don't know why it terrifies me, man. The sea just in general terrifies me, but diving in particular.
Diving.
I also love to be able to sing.
With the cage, without the cage?
Without the cage. And they keep making me swim with, like, dolphins and sharks and things for the show. And it's the most terrifying thing ever, man. But I will conquer it.
Okay.
Cool.
Round two. You're free to take anything home from the studio. What would you take?
The yogurt.
Oh.
I would love the yogurt.
The golden bunny.
No-lack dairy snack for the win. Okay. G-Man, are you ready? You're free to change jobs with one person in the studio for a day. I know who you're going to choose.
Lucian, one time.
I thought you would choose our Springbok rugby player that's here for the day.
Oh, he is in the studio today.
You lost out. Nope. Sorry.
Damn it, please. Can I have a superpower of going back in time to just change my answer?
Oh. Are you ready for round three?
Let's go.
Okay. You're free to change one thing about this world.
Oh, nice one.
Ooh, I don't have an answer. That's my honest answer. I don't have one right now. Of course, I would like to solve all of its problems. Let's just go with that. I would like to solve all of its problems, absolutely.
Everything. Yeah.
I was thinking you were maybe going to like suggest a three-day weekend.
I didn't think of that. And I'm trying to be honest.
It's easy when you're on that side of the fence, okay?
Okay, Graham, you're next. You're free to eat as much of this food as you want.
Wow. Again, there's just too many answers. Steak.
Steak?
Yeah.
Okay. Steak.
I would eat it every day if I could.
Okay. I think this is our last round, Kurt. Okay, you ready?
Yes.
Ooh.
You're free to skip the line at one place for the rest of your life. I already know the answer to this one.
Oh. Free
to skip the line.
Skip the line at one place.
He's already got that job. He can get into any stadium. He can go and watch any football game he wants.
Woolworths. I'll go Woolies.
That's clever. That is clever. I like that.
I would have chosen Home Affairs. Okay. Graham, last one. You're free to have any unanswered question about the universe answered.
Oh, what is time? What is it all? What does it really mean? I'd love to sit down with someone who's vastly more intelligent than me and just have them explain all of that to me entirely. I'd like to know that.
Gents, feel free to enjoy your Nolak, your granola and the little fresh fruit. But if you want to be free to eat and drink dairy again because of lactose intolerance, then you don't have to hope and wish. Just switch to Nolak and try their range of lactose-free milk and dairy snacks. The freedom is just a sip and scoop away. Say goodbye to nausea and cramps and say hello to delicious freedom with Nolak's range of lactose-free milk and yogurt. Be free with lactose-free. We are taking the quickest of breaks on your Feel Good Breakfast show. When we get back, we've got Durban Gorgor ready to perform for your Friday.
And then I ask you to excuse me in advance. Yes, I will probably get quite emotional. Why? Because we've got Vili and Holly LaRue in studio. Two incredible human beings. We cannot wait to find out about the latest chapter in their magical journey together. Stick around. We'll sit down with them after this.
It's my feel-good breakfast show.
Yep, the smile probably gives it away. It is a special one this morning. We have one for the books. The remarkable journey of a rugby star who we love, Vili LaRue, and a gut health specialist that stole his heart, a chef, Holly LaRue. They have tied the knot. And from Vili's dazzling career in rugby to Holly's pioneering culinary endeavours alongside their recent wedding, we get to uncover the captivating story of this dynamic couple who we love so much. Can we get a massive round of applause for Vili and Holly for just waking up and being here this early. Thank you so much. I'm sure in the post-honeymoon glow, you just want to chill.
Yeah.
We appreciate you guys being here so much. Thank you, man.
Oh,
thank
you.
And congratulations on your nuptials. That's very exciting.
Yeah.
Holly, I'm going to start off for you. What was the highlight of the day for you?
I mean, I think it was very special. There were so many, but I think Billy and I actually wrote our own vows, which is a big moment. I think Billy doesn't really like public speaking so much. So, yeah, and I even said a little bit in Afrikaans. So, yeah,
okay.
That was nice.
Special, yeah.
I know it's an emotional kind of whirlwind. Do you remember the wedding? Are there just moments that kind of pop out? How are you feeling now that you've kind of come back down to earth?
Yeah, no, definitely there's moments. It's family and friends all the time, everywhere. Then the band start playing late that night. I think that's what everyone was waiting for.
Then you can let go.
They just wanted to let the speeches get out of the way and those things. And then everyone just wanted to take their ties off and have a good time. So I think that's what I remember the most is when the band started playing, the dance floor was full and busy and we were all just having a lekker jol.
Those photos look incredible. Exquisite. Oh my goodness, exquisite. I actually wanted to ask you this, Holly, because I got married at the end of last year and I feel like every groom makes a couple of suggestions.
Yeah.
And then you veto it. Or they're not a fan of something you suggest and you veto their no. Yeah. Was there anything?
Well, I mean, we literally planned this wedding through a World Cup. So we very much separated and I was like, you do you and I'm going to do me. So we had to kind of tag team out. So I definitely was front runner with the wedding planning and Billy front runnered the World Cup. So, yeah, so it was good, yeah.
How do you split your mind like that? Were you able to separate wedding and rugby during that time? Or how did your anxiety handle that period of your life?
No, there was, at that time, we said the main job now is the World Cup. That's the number one prize goal for us, for South Africa back home. And that where all my focus was. Holly was there supporting and everything she could do to help me off the field. And then I knew when we were going to get back home, I'm going to start getting, okay, Willie, you have to do this, you have to organize this, you have to plan this.
So,
a big list, to-do list. But yeah, so during that World Cup period of time, there was no chat about getting married and stuff like that. We were solely focused on our goal and our job for the Springboks.
As you could see, man.
Yeah.
As we could see.
Oh, well, you just came back from your honeymoon. Do you miss being in that honeymoon bubble? Now it's back to reality, or are you ready to hit the ground running as it's the start of the new year?
Well, I feel like honeymoon period is like a real thing. I think when you start dating someone, they say, oh, you're in honeymoon period. Then you actually get to honeymoon period. It's a real thing. It's amazing. I feel like you just kind of obsessed with each other and just want to live in each other's shoes. Like, it's just really lovely.
Aww.
So, but yeah, it's taken, I think this week has felt a bit funny. I felt like really lost. Like, okay, I'm not planning a wedding and not speaking to my wedding planner every day. Like, what do I do?
Yeah.
Where did you go? What was the honeymoon like? Yeah. Reveal.
We went to Mauritius. Yeah. It was our first time there. We've both never been. Mm. We're both serious water babies. So lots of swimming with dolphins, turtles. Billy even got stung by a jellyfish.
Oh, goodness.
That's one
guy. Yeah, no, that wasn't fun.
You do know the antidote to being stung with a jellyfish,
well,
right?
We were told, we know that.
That's love. That's real love.
Okay. We didn't do that.
We were actually told that rum is the cure from the Mauritians. So.
Okay.
Yeah.
They don't believe the South African way of doing it.
I have a feeling someone just tricked someone once and then they loved the joke and they just carried that on. You guys get to look forward now in a slightly different manner. I think you've been very supportive of each other throughout this period, so that's obviously not going to change. Mm. Now you're a team and you get to focus on your careers as a team. Does it feel different in that respect? Maybe from a rugby perspective, are you looking at where you're going and how you are kind of setting yourself up slightly differently now that you're married? Or does it feel like this is just a continuation of where you've been going?
Yeah, no, definitely. Obviously, we've been a team for the last 6 years. But now, obviously, we're married, so you're a stronger team.
It's on paper.
Yeah, it's on paper. So, yeah, now I think you have to think a lot more before you make decisions in rugby, because rugby is so highs and lows and ups and downs. And today you're in South Africa, tomorrow you're in Japan, or you're all over the world. So it tends to get tough, like that you have to support each other no matter what. And then I think when I'm going to make decision about where I would be going next in the next few years, if I had to go somewhere else, then we would have to sit down and talk about that. Where earlier, I think I might have told Holly, listen,
this is the
I'm
plan.
On my
yeah.
way to Japan now. If you want to come with, come along. And yeah, so this year we have to set out that the plans and talk about it. I think that's where we will be at. Yeah.
So if he comes home speaking Japanese, just yeah. very coyly, just you know, just pick up the hint. Just yeah. pick up the hint.
Yeah. But it's all very exciting. The unknown is extremely exciting. Yeah. I know there are quite a few couples in my circle of friends getting married. Perhaps, Holly, from your perspective, any advice if there's perhaps something you wish you'd done differently around the planning process, or now that you look in hindsight, what you would have, you know, maybe encouraged girls to enjoy more at their wedding, yeah. what would you say to them?
I think the best decision we both made was hiring our wedding planner, Shan Lavender. She's absolutely phenomenal, and every single crazy request I threw at her, she absolutely smashed it, so she was great. And hire a very good photographer and do an engagement shoot. Mm. I think we both are not completely comfortable around photographs and doing like photographs together. So having that exposure like together and building that bond, especially with your photographer, that's like a key takeout definitely for weddings.
Because it does matter, and you yeah. do go back, and now you'll have thousands. I have thousands from my yeah. wedding. I got married less than a year ago, and Vili, maybe I can put it to you like this, because there were so many moments during that wedding journey where I was looking back over my life. That's just such a big thing. Yeah. What did you think about at the beginning? Did you have a moment to think about the World Cup, think about these achievements? What kind of jumped out in that space for you, man?
Yeah, so like you say, it's an emotional thing, the getting married and stuff. And when Holly came down with a car and she walked in there, it's a different emotion. I was trying to think of, where am I going to put myself on a rugby field in front of 80,000 people and singing the national anthem, and I'm going to try and compare things like that, but it's totally different. It's hard to do. You can't. It's just a special occasion, and something that you're not going to do again. So just under a surreal feeling. The day went so fast. Like I said, we couldn't. I don't think I said hello to everyone at the wedding. That's how quick it went. So yeah. that's a sad part. You can't get to everyone.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
Oh, but they would have felt it, man. They would have felt
definitely.
It.
Definitely. Were you as nervous proposing as you were perhaps leading up to a big
yeah, it was actually proposing. It was nervous. I think when compared to the rugby, if you. On a rugby field, everyone is like, don't you get nervous playing in front of 80,000 people? But it's my job and it's my
work. You know what you're going to do, yeah.
Yeah, and as soon as you might be nervous before the game, which is always a good thing. And then when you get onto the field, it's completely forget about it. And you've got a job to do and you focus on your job. It was a bit out of my comfort zone proposing and stuff. I got nervous, but it's part of it.
I absolutely love the fact that you have a moment now to take stock after what must have been the craziest couple of years. Mm. I've got to ask you, because if I, being as emotionally invested as I am, just as a normal South African, yeah. what was it like for you to have a front row seat to the last few months of this journey? Well, to be in it, to be in the coalface.
Yeah.
How did you survive? How was your anxiety doing after the last few months?
We've been in this for 6 years, so we're very good at communicating with one another, and when one of us is high, then the other one is low, and you kind of just have to balance that out. And I think within rugby, you have to choose a partner that's very good at adapting to change. So I think I've mastered that. I've always been excited for change, like moving countries, or we've got a World Cup, or we're moving to a new hotel. Like, it's hectic, it's busy, but it is exciting, and I think choosing that right partner makes you not feel anxious. You're just like, it's okay, we've got it.
Yeah, you have to embrace it.
Definitely. Oh, well, we're so excited that both of you get to hang out with us today. We're going to play a couple of games. We're going to be in the kitchen because I know you are the specialist there. So have some fun with us today. If you perhaps have any questions for Vili or Holly, you're welcome to let us know on social media. It is our Good Morning post today. Perhaps send a voice note. Our number is 063-408-8863. We'll be getting those answers to your questions.
We claim that we are the biggest and best breakfast show in the country, and this is why, my love, we prove it to you each and every day. And we have got in the building party starters, the people who are truly going to make the weekend start off so nicely. I am talking about none other than Devon Gogo, Leandro Verge, as well as Dr. Tools doing Utando! Weekend officially open. Madam President Devon Gogo and her delegation, they have said it is so, and thus it is on your Feel Good Breakfast show. We still got these huge, amazing acts in the building here at the Joburg Studios at the Samsung Showroom in Design Quarter, but we also have a whole lot still coming your way from Cape Town as well. This is why Zoe is standing by in the kitchen.
Oh, thank you, Sanele. Well, you know what? We are going to head into the kitchen soon because we've got a delicious one-pot recipe that we want to share with you. And then we have very, very, very special guests with us today. Holly and Vili LaRue are with us. They are the newlyweds, and we're going to have a lot of fun with them. We've got questions we have to ask. We have to get some answers from them. We want to cook some delicious recipes. And it's so great that they're hanging out with us today on your Feel Good Breakfast show. So we'll see you in just a bit. Holly, you can make my day.
It's my Feel Good Breakfast Show.
Welcome back, you beauties. Yes, we are buzzing this morning. Why? Because we have rugby royalty in the house this morning. Vili and Holly are newlyweds as well, but they've been together a while. They've been a power couple driving a beautiful narrative, and we are so happy to be plugging into that this morning. So thank you so much for being here. And of course, we put it to you guys at home. If you've got any questions, if you want to say anything, this is your opportunity. And we've got a couple of comments have come through right now. So let's turn to the socials and see Poppy saying, oh, wow, these two are super amazing. We had a pleasure of meeting Vili at Loftus last January, and my son was super excited to meet him. In fact, the whole of Delmas Lar School knows these moments. He's just a humble person. Congratulations to you guys. That's a lovely message. Thank you so much, Poppy. It's amazing how many people you would have met over the last few months. How many South Africans do you think you've met and shaked hands with or hugged in the last few months, dude?
Yeah, I know. Obviously, when you go somewhere, you go to a mall or you're just up in Pretoria now, the people live for rugby there as well. So if you just go out to get some food or go somewhere, walk on the roads, they stop you, you take pictures and stuff, which is amazing. And to see the support we got from everyone, and they helped us through this all, and we did this for them. So yeah, it's just an amazing and surreal feeling.
And we felt it, man. Zanele in Johannesburg's got a question she'd like to throw out there. Z, what are you gonna say?
Yes, I do have a question, actually. And firstly, guys, I just want to say I love you so much. Everything you've done for the country, you are superheroes, okay? And speaking of which, I think it would have taken a superhero mentality to be able to get through that really crazy time where each week we were winning by 1 point in the Rugby World Cup. I need to know, especially as the people who were the main players in that situation, what was going through your mind? Because for us, we were sitting at home nervous. What was happening in terms of in Paris with you guys and the team?
Yeah, so I think obviously I was on the bench watching as well, like everyone else back home. So then you must think, if you know you're going to have to go on, how nervous you are. So that's a bit of a different story. But yeah, just watching the boys from the side playing and trying to see what we can do better, where we can have an opportunity somewhere to create something or to get some momentum back on our side. And then when you get called upon and you have to go up, it's your time to shine and to help the guys and do what you to do there for. So yeah, it's not easy to sit on the bench and watch as well. I have a bit of the feeling that what the people felt back home, I got that same sense inside me. But then you have to go on and you can actually go try and do something about it, where I think everyone back home, it's tough for them to because they can't do anything about it. Mm-hmm. They can just shout as loud as they can.
Yeah, we scream. Well, in fact, there were rules in my house of how I was allowed to behave whilst watching the games. Zanella, you're on the money there. I absolutely love the fact that the whole country was in that. Did you feel that from those connections?
Even
there, I know it was kind of a hostile space to be in, and I've had it from Evan and others, that it was pretty, pretty hectic.
Yeah.
How did it felt from your perspective?
Yeah, I mean, it's amazing. We have such an incredible family at the Springboks, especially within the women. Like, we are best friends. Like, I feel like when I see them, we saw quite a few of them at our wedding, it's like you see family again. So having that support system when you are on the sidelines watching is unbelievable.
Z, you got another question?
Yes, indeed, I do. And it is for the Queen. I need to ask you, because I mean, I feel like everybody wants to know what is happening in the lives of these beautiful ladies who are the pillars of these men that we look up to. And we look up to you guys as well. You know, how does it, you know, really work for you in terms of making sure that you guys keep your life private as well and just have something that's for you, because you're already, you know, such a huge part of the public?
Yeah, I mean, I think I post quite a bit about my chefing career on my profile, but we do keep quite a lot of stuff to ourselves. I think Vili is very much in the public eye, and that's his world.
Yeah.
And I think there are a lot of private moments that we keep to ourselves, which I think is important. You need that little bit of privacy, and we try and share as much as we can. But it's nice to have those little intimate moments together.
I don't think you have a choice. You have to share. I absolutely love that. Z, we'll chat to you in just a sec. It is a strange thing when you've got to walk that line, because I think you guys established that the responsibility on your shoulders is something that seems to be embraced. It's not this yoke that hangs over you. It's something that you rise to, that you enjoy, that you live every day. And I love the fact that you guys were able to be that voice, be the PR agents, play that role, and still deliver in the way that you did on the field. It's just mind-blowing. going to me. The tears will probably come at some point when all of this really sinks in. Villy and Holly are not going anywhere. They are here to have a little bit of fun. And yes, we're going to put their bonds to the test because all newlyweds need to prove how much they love each other. That game will happen after this.
Well, it's now 7 o'clock. Let's quickly look at your national headlines. The Gauteng police have arrested 12 suspects during an operation in Marabastad, Pretoria, and seized counterfeit goods worth at least 8 million rand. This includes clothes and shoes. A police spokesperson, Amanda van Wyk, says officers from various specialist units, as well as officials from the Internal Affairs and Revenue Services, participated in the operation. The suspects are undocumented foreign nationals. 2 weeks ago, the police seized counterfeit goods worth some 13 million rand during an operation in the Johannesburg city centre. And President Cyril Ramaphosa has urged male traditional leaders to open dialogues with other men to help stop gender-based violence. He was speaking at the opening of the National House of Traditional and Khoisan Leaders in Cape Town yesterday. Ramaphosa called on male traditional leaders to be part of this effort and to start their own men's dialogues. He said dialogue had shown to be effective in ending the abuse of women and girls. GBV continues to tear communities apart, he said. And the most luminous object ever detected has been spotted in the distant universe. It's a quasar, the bright core of a galaxy that is powered by a gargantuan black hole, some 17 billion times the mass of our sun. Known as J0529-4351, the object's power was confirmed in observations by the Very Large Telescope in Chile. Scientists reporting in the journal Nature Astronomy say the black hole has a voracious appetite, consuming the mass equivalent to one sun every day. And Kenya has exempted passport holders from South Africa and six other countries from paying an unpopular entry fee introduced last month. In January, the government scrapped visa requirements for all foreign passport holders to promote the country as a tourist destination and to attract business travellers. In addition to South Africa, Kenya also scrapped visa requirements for Ethiopia, Eritrea, Congo-Brazzaville, the Comoros Islands and Mozambique. Europe's third smallest nation, San Marino, is the only other country on the exemption list. And in a pivotal victory against confining exotic wild species in South Africa, the NSPCA and the Boksburg SPCA achieved a milestone yesterday. Two white Bengal tigers held captive for some 2 years in Boksburg on Gauteng's East Rand were liberated from their constrained life in a barren urban enclosure reduced to mere objects of human amusement. Collaborative efforts by NSPCA's Wildlife Protection Unit, the Boksburg's SPCA Inspectorate and big cat vet Dr. Peter Caldwell ensured their safe sedation and transfer to an accredited wildlife facility. It was quite emotional to see them taking excited leaps to freedom once their paws touched grass for the very first time. The NSPCA continues to oppose non-conservation confinement and breeding. Well, that is where I leave your morning headlines for now. Let's take another look at your sport with Graham.
Thank you so much, Joe. Taking quite a broad sweep this morning, we start with international football and World Cup winner Toni Kroos has confirmed his return to the German national team. That's ahead of Euro 2024, which will be hosted, of course, in Germany. The 34-year-old midfielder who retired after Euro 2020 will be available for selection in upcoming friendlies against France and Netherlands. Germany aims to improve its performance following recent struggles, including a very early exit in the past two World Cups. And staying with footballing news, Spanish head coach Luis de la Fuente has signed a contract extension up until 2026, ensuring his leadership through the next World Cup in the United States, Mexico and Canada. So the Spanish Football Federation stated that this extension provides stability ahead of the European Championships in June. De la Fuente took over as coach back in 2022, following Spain's early exit from the World Cup in Qatar. Then on to some cricketing action currently playing out. Fast bowler Oddie Robinson, he has been included in the English team for their fourth test against India in Ranchi, marking his first match of the series. In fact, in the 30-year-old's last appearance for England was back in the third Ashes test in Headingley last year. And he replaces Mark Wood, while spinner Shoaib Bashir replaces Rehan Ahmed. And after a 434-run defeat in that third test, England currently training 2-1 in the five-match series. And then finally, on to golf, Charlie Woods, the 15-year-old phenom, the son of Tiger Woods, saw his hopes of qualifying for the PGA Tour event in Palm Beach Gardens sadly dashed after shooting a 16-over par, 86 rather, in a pre-qualifying event. Not his best day out. So despite aspirations to make it to the US PGA Tour, the Cognizant Classic, his round at Lost Lake Golf Club ended any chance of a tour debut. Mel Woods showed some promise early on, a rough patch at the par 4 seventh hole hindered his progress. So despite the setback, Woods maintained his composure. He showed some class, and as he has previously showcased, he has got some talent. And we've seen many exhibitions alongside his father, so I have a feeling we will see this young man reach that milestone pretty soon. But that's where we leave our sport for now. Let's get an update on the roads. They should be waking up now.
They are certainly awake, starting with traffic in Philippi, Cape Town. There is a road closures between the M7 Jakes Harwell and Stock Road due to protesting. Please make use of an alternative route this morning and exercise caution. Staying in Cape Town, there's also congestion on the N2 inbound at Jakes Harwell Drive. There are delays, so add extra travel time. That's your traffic. Let's take another look at your weather. And the SA Weather Service has issued a yellow level 2 warning for severe thunderstorms with a possibility of strong damaging winds and large amounts of small hail expected over the southwestern Free State and the southeastern parts of the Northern Cape. There's extreme high fire danger conditions over the interior of the Northern Cape, the northeastern interior of the Western Cape, the northern interior of the Eastern Cape, and the central and western parts of the Free State and the southwestern parts of the Northwest, as well as the extreme northern parts of Limpopo. Then there's a heat wave warning with persistent high temperatures, and that's expected over the eastern parts of the Northern Cape, in places over the Free State and Northwest until Saturday, but over the extreme northern parts of the Eastern Cape until tomorrow. It is 7 a.m. Let's take another look at your sunrise views. This one was sent in by Amanda from False Bay. Oh, look at that gorgeous view with the ocean in the front. If you would love to share your view like Amanda did, you're welcome to send us a voice note. In fact, that photo to our WhatsApp line. Our number is 063-408-8863. Here's another look at your temperatures for your Friday.
I want to seem surprised, but it's been that hot in Upington pretty much the entire week. So stay safe out there. As we always suggest, just stay indoors for the next 3 hours at least, because we're going to have some fun. Villiers and Holly Roux have been wonderful. They are being completely honest. So we're going to push that boundary as far as we can and test their knowledge of each other.
It's all fun and games. And then we're also going to spend some time in the kitchen cooking up a delicious one-pot meal, this time focusing on pilchards and rice. So some recipe inspiration coming your way. So don't go anywhere.
It's my Feel Good Breakfast Show.
Welcome back. It is your Feel Good Breakfast Show. It's Espresso on S3. 1 hour down, another two to go. And joining us right now, we have Mr. and Mrs. LaRue, Willie and Holly, and they are here. We are ready to play a little game with them. And this one is simple. It's just called How Well Do You Know Me? Well, we are going to ask them a series of random, completely random questions, and we have to see if they can know, if they know the answers to one another. So let's get into it. So you've got your board. I'm going to ask a straightforward question and you need to write down the answer to see if you know it well. Are you ready? Okay. Holly, I'm going to start with you. What is the go-to word Willy uses to describe you? Willy, you can write down the answer too if you perhaps have a word to see if she's correct. And Clay. Ah! Why?
Yeah, that's my middle name.
Oh!
So yeah, she doesn't call me Holly, he calls me Claire.
He calls you Claire. Yeah. Oh, that's special. Okay. Who would your partner be as a cartoon character? So I'm going to ask you that. So, Willy, if Holly had to choose a cartoon character, who would she be? It's a bit of a tough one. I mean, I don't know the last time you might have watched a cartoon. Holly, if you know, if you perhaps know the cartoon you would want to be, you can write that down too.
Ooh, I have no idea. Cartoon.
No, I'm just taking a guess.
Okay, let's see.
I don't have one.
You don't have one.
I don't remember the last time I watched a cartoon.
Okay, what would you suggest?
Bugs Bunny.
Bugs Bunny. Do you like your carrots?
Okay, I do actually.
Ah, yes, okay.
Healthy.
Okay, let's move on to the next question. And this is a question for both of you. And it plays on you being the chef. Yeah. The number one ingredient to maintain your relationship. Let's see, what's that ingredient for you? There's no right or wrong answers.
Maintain a relationship.
Yeah.
Oh, that's a food question.
Yeah, is it ingredient?
Like no. This is a play on the word.
Okay,
so just a quality
you, or,
you know, this thing that's a value that's very important to the two of you. So something that just to make sure you have a healthy relationship. Okay. Willy, what is an important ingredient for you? Trust, yes, that is good. Consideration, excellent ingredients. Next question. What item stood out for you on your very first date? So maybe I'm going to ask Willy this question. What stood out about Holly on your very first date? And Holly, what do you think he thinks stood out about you?
Yes.
About me,
on your first date. So we're thinking back 6 years now.
I know, our first date's a funny story.
Oh, I'm dying to hear that.
I'll say what stood out for me about him.
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh. Ah, okay. Oh, Willy, whenever you are ready. Let's see.
Oh, he's writing an essay.
Ah! You said?
I said it was nice, friendly, easy to talk to, and beautiful.
Oh, well, do you want to know what she said?
It's Nando's order.
So wait, are you telling me your first date was at Nando's?
It was at Nando's. When Willy was playing for Wasps in Leamington Spa. So it was after a game, and then he was like, okay, let's go for cheeky Nando's.
Okay.
And his Nando's order was phenomenal, and it will literally be my forever favorite. It's like that pita, is it like a pita wrap, and then it's got pineapple and chicken, and it's like a...
Oh, okay. Oh, we're all learning something new here. One more question for each of you. What is your favorite room in the house? Let's see if you guys have the same favorite room. We'll make this the last question.
Braai room.
The braai room, the kitchen. Can we merge that? Is that the same? The place where the food gets
set. Yes, it's open plan. So they're two together.
Oh, I love that. I love that. Okay, my producer's saying I must ask more questions. So next question is, what made your partner realize that you were the one? Was it the Nando's order?
Chicken Nando's.
Oh, these are tough questions. I know I promised you easy questions, but these are tough questions. Picking your brain very early in the morning.
I don't like these big words in English.
It's okay.
But in Afrikaans.
You can do it in Afrikaans.
I'm trying to still think.
Okay. Well, you can tell me. You can tell me.
Yeah, I just think the way she approached life and how she is and how happy and always friendly to everyone she is and her drive to succeed in life and to not scared for change. And like I say, when we have to pack up and go, we go and we move to different countries, she's always in for that. So yeah, I think.
And I understand why you didn't want to write all of that down. Holly, for you? Yeah,
mine was his drive. I think I'm very attracted to people that are driven and want more in life.
And
are focused, yeah, and are focused on their career and what they love doing. And I think, yeah, Willie is very focused and loves what he does. So that for me is, yeah, the best quality about him, actually.
All excellent qualities. Mm-hmm. I love that. Now, first thing you do, or in fact, first thing your partner likes to do after waking up. So, Willie, what's the first thing Holly does? Holly, what's the first thing Willie does?
Your on-season, off-season? That's a tough question. We'll go with currently.
Currently, yes. Yeah. Vili, do you want to reveal your answer so long?
She drinks water.
Drinks water.
Yeah, healthy.
Yeah.
Vili lately go for a run. He does a 5K and then comes back. He says, check what time I got.
The 5K run's very important.
Yeah.
Did he go for a run the morning after the wedding?
No, that was a bit of a hangover. No, we didn't. We had a good couch day.
Oh, well, that's how it should be. Okay, let's see. This is going to be our last question. What are your top two pet peeves? Thing that maybe irritates or irks. Doesn't have to be of each other, just in general. I personally don't like it when people don't indicate when they're about to turn or stop.
Oh, yes.
You can just tell me.
Yeah, I'll just tell. What is this? I don't know.
A pet peeve. Oh, okay. So Holly's backseat driving. I'm unfortunately the backseat driver in my relationship. Yeah.
No, Vili always has nice little tips while I'm driving all the time.
And for you, Vili?
I think maybe that when you climb into a lift for someone, that awkward silence.
Ooh.
It's not like it. Just say something and get it over.
Yes. Yeah. Or if you jump and you sit next to a stranger next to the plane, and you're like, are we going to greet each other or not? Are we going to say something? No, definitely those awkward moments can be pet peeves. Mm. Well, you guys are a lot of fun. Thank you for joining us. And we're going to be heading into the kitchen. But perhaps you have a question for Willy or Holly. You're welcome to let us know. We've got that on our Good Morning post for you. If you want to send a voice note, feel free to do so. Our number is 063-408-888. We'll be back with them shortly.
Now, if you're looking to stretch out those randellas and get more for less, we've got game. So this morning we are cooking up a storm with game More for Less Grocery Essentials. It's a heavy hitter. It's a one-pot wonder, pilchards and rice with unbeatable deals. You'll get more igroza for your buck, and that's what we all need, especially at this time of the year. So grab your pantry staples and join us as we whip up a hearty, healthy meal that's easy on the wallet and massive on flavour. And for this, I'm going to need my expert partner in the kitchen,
I'll
Zoe, to join
chef.
Us. I love the sound of, so that is on.
Yes,
I love the sound of a one-pot wonder because it means it's just all in one pot. So this one we just have to stage, but we've got obviously our pilchards, which are great. It's a non-perishable. It lasts long. It goes the extra mile. You can use it in a million different ways. We're going to use it in a beautiful rice kind of cook up here, one pot wonder. So we're going to put the oil in first and we're going to saute our onions first.
Our onions. There's just something about cooking with onions that I've been enjoying more and more lately.
I suppose there's a reason why it's kind of the base of French cooking, why it's so vitally important in so many cooking styles.
We'll,
if you want to turn that
down,
I think it's that one in the middle there. There is something about the flavor development in an onion that really works well in this context. So we're going to speed up the process just a little bit for the sake of TV.
You want your onions to be a little bit more on the translucent side.
Completely. So you make sure that they cook through. And remember, it is going to cook in the pot for about 20 minutes once we've introduced the rice and the rest of the ingredients. So we're going to move down our little production line here. We're going to add our finely diced carrots and our red peppers as well. And when we say a one-pot wonder, a lot of that must feed off what you've got in your kitchen. So if you've got some leftover carrots, got a bit of tomato, got whatever it is, this is the kind of recipe that lends itself to that. It really is literally a melting pot.
If you don't have red peppers, use the green pepper.
100%. Use whatever peppers you got. Then we're going to add our garlic, our paprika. I think this is a paprika, a little bit of salt as well.
And this is one of those recipes where we're building a lot of flavor.
Completely. And I think this is often what we forget is you don't need expensive ingredients to build complex flavors. You just need the right base to work off. And I think this is going to work beautifully in the flavor combination. So again, we'll probably cook those for about 2-3 minutes as the vegetables cook through, get a bit more translucent, as you say. And then we can have fun just adding the rest. So we've got our beautiful stock here. And again, use whatever stock you got. I find chicken stock just has the best flavor for me in terms of incorporating into other dishes. But if you like it a bit more meaty, if you want something that's got a bit more oomph, go for it. If you want a vegetable stock, if you want to keep it in that lane, go for it.
There you go. And it looks like a lot of water right now, or liquid, but we are adding rice.
Exactly.
And that's going to absorb all of the flavor and the moisture.
So now we've got our tinned tomatoes, of course, the hero ingredient, our pilchards. We've got some finely diced chili as well. We've got a nice green chili here. For this, I would go with like a bird's eye or something, add some real heat to it.
I have a confession to make.
Yes.
I have never in my life eaten pilchards.
Well, today is your day, girl. There is a first for everything. I think pilchards very much the unsung hero in many kitchens. And I love the fact that you can get your coup pilchards and tomato sauce, any four, for just 90 Rand. Now that speaks to the value. Then of course you can add your Mrs. Balls into the mix if you want. Chutney, a brilliant, brilliant flavor addition at the end if you want that extra kick. Okay, let's get our cup of rice in.
I'm gonna do a nice big cup.
There we go.
And I've got the heat here, so obviously just watching it, just wanted to get to a simmer. We don't want this to boil and burn.
There we go. And I think we have mixed in all our ingredients. You can add chili to taste. I don't know what you're like with a bit of heat. Do you like chili?
I've been enjoying heat, but I like something to counteract it. So if I'm going to add heat, I'll probably put a little bit of chutney to it, or perhaps some plain yogurt to just balance it out.
I
like heat,
that,
but I don't want it
sure.
to continue burning.
No, for sure. And I really do. I think you can develop the flavor with the spice as well. Now, when we get to the heart of this more for, less, it really does speak to some incredible staples that we want in our kitchen. What we love about the Mrs. Balls chutney for any 2 for 70 Rand deal is brilliant, because this can hang around in your kitchen. We love that. And then we've got the Excella rice, 2 for just 60 Rand. You group that all together, that's not just one meal, that's many meals for ridiculously low. And if you want to get your hands on this mouth-watering recipe, you can visit espressoshow.com. So we'd be waiting about 20 minutes for that to cook through, and then of course our beautiful dish will emerge. A one-pot wonder, smells absolutely amazing, and absolutely jam-packed with all the right kind of nutrients that you need.
Quick and easy. If you want to get your hands on this recipe, it is available on our website, espressoshow.com.
And let's add a little extra spice as I add the Mrs. Ball. You, of course, stand a chance to win a 2,000 Rand Game Stores shopping voucher. Imagine how much more you could get for less with that. Simply reply to the competition post on the Espresso Facebook, the X, or our Instagram page and tell us when you're looking for a big brand item. Which aisle at Game Stores do you visit first? And don't forget to hashtag GotGame. That competition closes the 29th of February. That's this Thursday at midnight. So you don't have a huge amount of time. Get on it, but you can find all the T's and C's at espressoshow.com. So it's time to shop, rock and roll with Game, where big brands meet unbeatable prices, as we have put on the table today. And so don't miss out. Share your aisle wisdom with us now, and hopefully you can be a winner. Those store opening hours again on Monday to Friday from 9 to 6, Saturday from 9 to 5, and then Sunday and public holidays from 9 until 4. It's coming along beautifully. It's smelling absolutely gorgeous. Go and try it for yourself. Oh.
Can you just imagine? We're only halfway through the show and we've still done so much and there's still so much more to do. And this is why you got to make sure you stay tuned to your Feel Good Breakfast show, because on the way, we're going to be getting to know hit maker Zinxumalo as well as DJ duo Shakes and Les. They are in the building and are going to be performing their hit track. Oh, and Tonga, that song, it hits me here in the heart, but we'll tell you more about it in a bit. But we also, my friend, are on a journey at the moment with Tropical Island of Treasure Season 11, Zanzibar, where we are finding out who are our celebrities. We're going to be revealing yet another one right here on Expresso in the next few. So make sure that you do not go anywhere, because it is all coming up right here on your Feel Good Breakfast show. We're going to take a short break, but you stay exactly where you are, because this is how you deserve for your beautiful weekend to begin right here on S3.
It's the little things that make big things happen. If you're a baking legend, then rise to the occasion and enter to be a contestant on the Tastemaster SA Season 5. Visit thetastemaster.co.za. Share a video introducing yourself and your baking skills and show us some pics of your incredible creations. Entries close on the 25th of February. T's and C's apply.
It's my Feel Good Breakfast Show. You're on S3, which can only mean one thing. It is Expresso, my lovely. The only way to start off your day. And listen, inkqubo yanamhlanje, hot, 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 hot menu it is. And this is why we had to bring the hit makers that are doing the things in the streets and making sure that South Africa is dancing, my friend. Listen, even if you're not a groovist winner, you're not partaking there out and about in the streets, it's okay, because this song right here, Funk 55, it is one that will genuinely get you up and dancing. And one thing I enjoy about it is that it was made by young people. And I am talking about three humans who are part of it, who made absolute waves in November 2023, but it's still going even now in 2024. And this is why we had to invite them over. Everyone, I need you to please welcome to the Johannesburg studio. It is Zinxumalo as well as DJ duo Shakes and Les. Guys, thank you for waking up for us.
Thank you for the opportunity.
Of course. Z, let's start with you, my baby. The rose amongst the... Yes, the rose amongst the thorns. Babe, tell us about how this beautiful story got started for you in terms of entering the music industry. And also, who gave you your very first opportunity?
I've had so many opportunities lately. I have to think about it.
Come on, that's right, girl.
But the biggest shout out to Melinda, the vocalist. I think he was one of the very few people in Sakala. About to say, was Angupi Ves? Was Angupelo? Let me post, let me do this. So the biggest shout out to him. And amongst the many other, about David Gogo, about Maporis, about DJ Tira.
Yeah, just naming all the big names. We're sorry, Z, okay? Yeah, in demand. But Yakala be for you, baby girl, in terms of singing.
Yeah, what's crazy is that Singakala nga cover ka Mlindo vele. So it only makes sense why he's the one that gave me the opportunity to actually go about and be an actual musician. Because mina ngaqala nga cover, bengifuna ma follower ku Twitter.
Yes.
Yeah. After the cover, it cover made it to YouTube. Now people are demanding actual music, not covers anymore. So that's how it...
That's beautiful. It's like a full circle moment of sorts. Oh, babes, that's so beautiful. But gents, what you guys have been doing as well has been so beautiful. Let's talk about how you met. How did this DJ duo come about? I also heard that church was in the mix somewhere. What happened? Shakes, you can start us off.
Okay, yeah, church really is in the mix.
Yes.
I would say church is a cool, the school of music.
Yes.
So I grew up in a family church, so musical, like family.
Yeah.
Most everyone there like was in music, some were playing instruments, so the influence was like easy to grab.
It was there. I love that. Yeah. And Liz, Nina, where did you guys come together?
Similar story. I also started in church.
Yeah.
Started playing keys. And then we met via social media.
Love.
Started sharing music.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
Guys,
yeah,
that's crazy. Wait, so wait, how many years has it been now?
I can say 3-4 years.
Hi, thank you, social media. Because what? And also, guys, you've come out and said that, you know, Brazilian music is what you call your sound.
Yeah.
Speak to us about that. Why?
Because of the sounds that they use when they create their music, Brazilians. They use so many instruments. So when I was like, we have to be unique because I'm a pianist. It's easy to make piano. Anyone can be a star. So we had to be different, unique, and have our own sound. So hence why we said, let's say Brazilian music.
Come on. Yeah. I love that. And I think it's so incredible that you decided to be like, okay, let's be different. Because it's so easy to say, let's do what everyone else is doing. Speaking of which, though, Z, my babes, you are someone who has been collaborating with so many people. I mean, you mentioned all of them. The Tiras, the Maporisas, the Devon Gogos. Let's talk about this collaboration with Shakes and Liz and Devon Gogo. How did that come about?
Yo, ever heard of God's timing?
Amen. Amen. Take us to church, girl.
I mean, they started in church.
Yes, exactly. So,
yeah, I think it was one of those moments.
If you want to sing, it's okay. We're ready.
Shakes are going to respect.
He's just making you warm up for later, yabo.
Anyways, it was one of those moments where you're not planning anything. You're there in studio. I didn't know who they were. Remember, and it didn't happen, so we happened to be you know why it's good timing. So maskibele ubane uHenry is like ungidlalela ingoma yabo no Chopper. I'm like ngiyizwa le vocalist abubani laba be producer le ngoma, but to Shakes and Liz, I'm like angibaza ku Shakes and Liz. We worked, and then when we went back home, they're like, by the way, yibona Shakes and Liz labaya.
Oh wow. It was meant to be, guys.
Alignment.
Exactly.
That's how the song came about.
Oh man, and it's such a beautiful song, guys. I can't wait to dance to it later. But Z, I want to ask you, for 2024, what can we expect from the queen that is you?
Yeah, sing you queen.
Babe, you must. You have to be the person that you already want to be. Come on.
I guess more music, more branding.
Yes.
More music, man. Because you're a musician after all.
I love that.
Yeah.
I love that. And gents, for 2024, what can we expect from you?
Yo, more music also for us. More funks.
More funks. More hits. Thank you very much.
More hits.
Also, like, People must just attend our shows.
You see what I'm saying? I was gonna ask, are you guys planning on doing shows? I'll be them, like, guys, front and center, ne?
Yeah,
I'll be there. Beautiful. Thank you so much, guys, and I can't wait for you to blow us away with that beautiful Funk 55. And it is coming your way, Expresso family. And this is why you gotta make sure that you stick around. One of the most beautiful things is how we get to know our musicians that are genuinely making waves all over the country and beyond. For now, though, you need to stick around because there's so much more on the way right here on your Feel Good Breakfast Show.
Oh, thank you, yep. Sanele. Well, listen, we are super excited because we know you are going to be the host for the next Tropica Island of Treasure because it is returning with you as our very own host. Okay. Now, if you've missed that, yes, Sanele is the new host and she will be jetting off to Zanzibar with singer Bobby van Jaarsveld and TikTok dancing sensation Chad Jones. Those are the two celebs we have added to the pot.
Fiercely competitive. I know Bobby is on another level competitive, which is going to be crazy, too physically gifted. Awesome. But let's give you a reminder of yesterday's clue for today. You have been flooding social media with all of your brilliant suggestions and guesses of who might be heading to the Island of Treasure as the next big celeb. So let's take a look at some of your guesses from our social platforms.
Okay. Well, like we it. Have people guessing. It is the singer-songwriter Londi London. Could it be? Okay. Could
I
it
like
be?
That. Mm-hmm. She looks ready for it. And we've got actress and model Natasha Tahane. Mm-hmm. Ooh, okay. I like that name in the hat.
I quite like this celebrity chef, Lorna Maseko.
She loves an island. We did some shooting in the Maldives together. She loves a bit of island life. She would fit into that mold.
Definitely.
And bring a little bit of spice to the Spice Island as well. Well, let's take a look at exactly who the next two celebs heading to Zanzibar are. Yeah, congratulations. Omutle Gela is on the way. I'm not tearing up, I promise. It's just a frog
You're
in the throat.
Excited.
But it is a massive, massive opportunity.
Omutle, we are so excited that you are joining the team because you're extremely talented. If you don't know who she is, she's a talented actress and has appeared on numerous television shows throughout her career. In addition to her acting, Omutle has also launched a swimsuit line, 20 Swimwear in 2014, and she owns a nail salon. I can guarantee
she's
going to have the wardrobe for Zanzibar locked down.
Absolutely
Perfect
sorted. She loves spending a little time in the swimsuit, and now she's going to get to compete in it, literally live in it, in the most beautiful setting, and possibly win her share of $1 million. So we still have another four celebrities to announce to add to the mix. So you've still got plenty of time to guess and, of course, win. And in the meantime, we're going to leave you with this little clue.
Well, we know it's a man.
I know who this person. You know when you know. I've got a vibe, but I'm not going to say anything. No, I don't know.
Okay, I think I know.
But I don't know. If you've got any idea who that gent could be, head over to @mytropica right now. Then comment using the hashtag Tropica, and you could win yourself R1,000 in cash right now. Now that is smooth, but of course the T's and C's apply.
Who do you think the celebrity is? Let us know.
I think I know.
Do you know? I can't believe you know. Oh, well, we're going to take the quickest of breaks. We have another performance coming your way, all the way from Johannesburg with Sanele. So we are super excited for that.
And then, of course, Vili and Holly are very graciously sticking around all morning to have a little bit of fun with us. And we've got Holly in the kitchen doing what she does best. She's going to whip up something truly scrumptious and very nutritious as well on the other side of the stick around. Holly, you can make my day.
It's my Feel Good Breakfast Show.
Welcome back. It is your Feel Good Breakfast Show, and we are very excited because Holly LaRue is in the kitchen and she is going to show us this delicious dish. Now, if you follow Holly on social media, you will know that she makes, the types of meals she loves to make. So we had to taste it for ourselves. Now, we have got the air fryer ready and going, and Holly, you've got a beautiful little sauce going there for us. Talk me through what we are making today.
So these are gluten-free air fryer meatballs. Ooh. And they're my pre-game meatballs that I feed Billy. So he normally has like pasta, good carbo load before a game. And these are super easy, and for all the people who are gluten intolerant, it's a really great recipe. Use gluten-free pasta as well. And a really good, like, it's a very basic tomato sauce. Which
the heat is over there for us. Yes, if you just want to dial it down a little bit.
Yeah. And it's a very basic mirepoix, my favorite French word. Ooh. It's one of the first French words I learned, and it's literally a mixture of carrot, celery, and onion, and that's your base. And then you add all your tomatoes, your flavor, a good glug of red wine, some balsamic to sort of balance out the flavors. And that's kind of just your basic tomato sauce, which you can use in any pasta dish.
Yes, and it sounds incredible, but we're also going to add some mince to that.
Yes.
Well, this is more for the meatballs.
For the meatballs, yeah. And you've got a mixture of beef and pork, and you've got to make sure that your beef and pork is fatty. Don't be scared of fat, guys. It's not the enemy.
Okay.
It's where your flavor lies.
Yes.
And then it's so easy. You literally just bung it all in there, mix it all together.
Okay, I'll get that in for us. We're adding some onions.
Yes.
We're going to add some fresh garlic.
Yes. Yeah, and it's really nice to also weigh out your meatballs once you form the meatballs, just to get like a really even cook on it, and aesthetically it looks beautiful.
Definitely.
And the secret ingredient, so gluten-free is basically gluten in things, it binds things together. So my secret ingredient is potato starch in this, which is actually really good for digestion. So potato starch, secret ingredient, and we just mix that all together and form our balls.
Is someone in your family gluten intolerant? Tolerant that you focus on a gluten-free meal, or do you just find there's more benefits to it?
Well, that's specifically what I do as a chef, is I help people with intolerances, whether it's lactose intolerant, gluten-free, or if you've got a nut allergy, shellfish. So it's part of chefing that a lot of chefs are terrified of, but it's also a reality. I think quite a lot of people nowadays have gut health issues. So it's something that I really love doing. But I myself, is he beeping?
Okay, I just added an egg. Our air fryer is beeping. I'm assuming it's ready.
Okay, let's have a look.
So I'm gonna open it up for us. Oh, they are beautiful.
They look fantastic. Okay.
Look at these.
Okay, those pop straight into the sauce actually, Zoe.
Okay,
yeah.
So what I've done is I've added the egg. We're gonna add some chili flakes, and that is what we made the meatballs of. You simply pop it into the air fryer. You've got it?
Yeah.
There we go. Oh, I mean, an air fryer is life-changing.
Yes.
How often do you use your air fryer?
I use it quite a lot now. I've got a massive one, but you can have whatever size suits you, and it's super quick, super easy, and it's just nice for people like who want after work, if they've got like a quick meal they want to bung in there. But I think a lot of air fryer recipes in the past have been quite unhealthy.
Oh, I was about to say, I just know how to put chips in my air fryer, and I don't know how to make the healthy things.
Yeah.
So I'm hoping you'll change that perspective.
Yes. So I try and make it as healthy as possible. You mentioned earlier about gut health. I actually struggled with gut health for many years.
Okay.
So I used to be gluten-free. I used to be completely dairy-free. Now I just focus on lactose. So it's something that's a big passion project of my own personal stuff. But it's also stuff that I help other people with.
Mm. Because I know there's a lot of people struggling with their gut, and it often reflects. And the funny thing is, when things aren't right in your gut, it reflects in other areas of your life.
Absolutely.
In your skin, your stomach, it all plays a role. Now, if anyone wants to know more information, perhaps if they want to be in touch regarding, your expertise, is there a way they can maybe reach out?
Yes, for sure. I think I get like over 100 DMs a day. People who are really struggling with their intolerances and how to manage that on a day-to-day life basis, and how to deal with food and what to avoid and where should they shop and what ingredients are safe, or that kind of thing. So DM me, absolutely. I'm here to help. And guide you on what probiotics you would like to use, what shops to shop at, what ingredients are good. So,
okay.
Yeah.
You might be the perfect person to ask this because we've recently introduced a probiotic into our life.
Yeah.
And I wanted to know from you, when is the best and when is the worst time to actually consume a probiotic?
So it depends on the probiotic, but I consume mine after I've eaten so that it can work on all that food. So it needs something to work with. Yeah, I wouldn't recommend taking it on an empty stomach.
Okay.
Okay, I think we're
look
ready
at this.
To go.
So we've got some gluten-free pasta. I mean, if you want to go cauliflower or any of the veggie pastas with zucchini noodles, that can
like,
also
even, like,
work.
Even like butternut noodles and all sorts.
Those are my new
favorite
ones.
People are getting really innovative lately. I love it.
You get all your veggies in. Yeah. I will finish this off with some parmigiane for us.
Lots of that. That's delicious.
Lots of that.
Yeah.
Where did your love for food? I know you've had your own health, you know, that you've been focusing on and that passion stemmed from there.
Yeah.
Where did your love, where would you say it ignited from for cooking?
100% in Japan. Vili and I spent quite a few, we spent 4 years there.
Sure.
And yeah, I absolutely fell in love with Asian cuisine. It's amazing. It's just the ingredients that are available there are incredible. Let's turn this guy.
Look at this. Ooh. It's raining Parmigiana.
Delicious. And then I kind of just taught myself how to cook when I was there. And then after that, I was like, no, I need to go to chef school. So I went to Silwood Chef School, which is actually in Cape Town, and it's the top chef school in Africa.
They are
fantastic, really amazing, and just had the best experience there.
Oh, fantastic. So you've just showed us how to make this delicious gluten-free, in fact, meatballs and spaghetti.
Yes.
We have your husband here. Vili, do you want to come and join us? Perhaps have a little TV taste. I feel like we need to season with some salt.
Yes.
I can, please.
And some pepper. Yeah. All the ingredients.
Good old Jamie Oliver.
I know. Trying to get the spices in there.
Yeah.
Oh, but you know what? An air fryer is life-changing in terms of the healthy things we can do.
Absolutely.
When it comes to popping something healthy in here, quick and easy, when you get home from work, what would you recommend or what's your go-to?
Oh, butternut, always.
Butternut.
Always, yeah. And you put a spice on it, some salt and pepper, and then just bung in a little bit of olive oil, bung it in there, and it's so quick to do.
Oh, I love that. Butternut, I'll keep that in mind.
Yeah.
Vili, you gave us the traditional sign for okay, or is it...
Baie lekker.
Baie lekker.
No, very nice, very nice, very nice.
Yeah. How's your Afrikaans?
Not so great, but I am learning. little day by day. Yeah, how do you think it is?
It's getting... Baby steps. Yeah, no, she's getting better.
Oh.
You can obviously understand a lot better now than when I met her.
Yeah.
She's getting better and practicing a lot. So,
one day. Do you find with her incredible cooking, you have to kind of watch what you eat? Or are you one of those very blessed people that can eat anything and still stay trim?
No, when I'm up in Pretoria now, I'm alone a lot of the time, so I have to try and make my own food or just go get food that's easy. Or I love sushi, so I just go buy sushi a lot of times. But when Ollie's with me, we eat all these nice things with
healthy.
All the good ingredients, healthy and all of that. But it's when I'm on my own that I'm not so healthy, but I'm trying my best to.
Well, listen, I feel like there's a new business idea. Meals for them to just pop in the microwave and it's got a touch of Holly. Yes, there we go. I love what we've done here. Holly, thank you so much for showing this incredible recipe. And if you want to get your hands on this full recipe, all the ingredients we use, including the steps, you can just head on over to our website. That's expressoshow.com. Now, there's one extra plate. Who's going to get that? I'll take it.
Yeah.
Earlier on, we declared the weekend officially open, and now, my friend, the festivities continue. Please, Expresso family, welcome with open arms because they are just so amazing. Zin Nxumalo, Durban Gogo, and Sheikh Saleem.
Sheikh Selassie,
Ala,
Ozwe,
Zinqumalo,
Samange,
Yazala, Samanga, Mufasu, Lala, Mashia, Samanga, Lesson, Yoda.
tell it us my dad. Somebody now I'm so glad. Ah, for sure pass. And then I let so try. So tell it us my dad. Ah, yeah.
Talent, my friend, and this is what we only ever serve you up on your Feel Good Breakfast show. These superstars, ne, I'm gonna try and quickly just convince them to come back next week because that was a party. However, right about now, we are going into a very short break and we'll be on the other side of this.
Welcome back, you beauties. Oh, just 1 hour left to savor with you and this gorgeous human being stood beside me. It is awards season, of course, and we need a tally up. Who's won what, my friend? So I'm going to ask JP Sebastian to think about the biggest winners in Movieland, in Tinseltown, and we'll get through that in just a moment. Then we're going to sit down again with Avili and Holly LaRue, have a bit of a chat about life moving forward. Cannot wait for that. Buddy, cheers, man. Cheers
to you and you too.
The big film stars. Our we'll award. See who the biggest of all of them are after this.
Thank you, gentlemen. It's 8 o'clock. Let's take a final look at your headlines. The joint meeting of the committees of Parliament dealing with public finances have expressed mixed views on the use of the gold and foreign exchange contingent revenue account. This follows the announcement by Finance Minister Enoch Godongwana during his budget speech that the government will use some 150 billion rand from the reserve account to reduce borrowing and debt service costs. Godongwana faced tough questions from MPs about the government's plan to reduce borrowing by using the reserve account. Opposition members were unhappy about the move. And the Gauteng police have arrested 12 suspects during an operation in Marabstad in Pretoria and seized counterfeit goods worth at least 8 million rand. This includes clothes and shoes. A police spokesperson, Amanda van Wyk, said officers from various specialist units as well as officials from the Internal Affairs and the Revenue Service participated in the operation. The suspects are undocumented foreign nationals. 2 weeks ago, the police seized counterfeit goods worth some 13 million rand during an operation in the Johannesburg city centre. And Mauritius grounded flights as a strong tropical storm was approaching the Indian Ocean island yesterday. Storm Eleanor was about 200 kilometres northeast of the nation yesterday afternoon and was moving at a speed of 20 kilometres an hour, the weather service said. It added that the wind would strengthen to over 120 kilometres an hour. The country's main international airport operator said the facility would soon close, with national carrier Air Mauritius cancelling flights scheduled for departure today. Public transport was also halted and schools shut. And the most luminous object ever detected has been spotted in the distant universe. It's a quasar, the bright core of a galaxy that powered by a gargantuan black hole, some 17 billion times the mass of our sun. Known as J0529-4351, the object's power was confirmed in observations by the Very Large Telescope in Chile. Scientists reporting in the journal Nature Astronomy say the black hole has a vivacious appetite, consuming the mass equivalent to one sun every day. And celebrating its 20th anniversary, George is geared and ready for the Otanikwa Chair Challenge tomorrow, a dual competitive event welcoming not wheelchairs, but also racing chairs, hand cycles and basketball chairs. Organised by Alvain Dippenaar, the event features categories for quadriplegic and Paralympic athletes and subcategories based on chair type. Additionally, a lively 5 kilometre fun course sees wheelchair competitors paired with enthusiastic helpers. Drawing participants from Namibia, Ghana, Zimbabwe, Nigeria and Botswana, the Otanikwa Chair Challenge 2024 unfolds at the Carpe Diem School in George from today. The official opening is at 6 p.m. and tomorrow, kickoff early, is at 7 a.m, culminating in an award ceremony at lunchtime. Well, that's where I leave your headlines. Let's take one final look at your sport.
Oh, thank you so much. So after that inspirational note, let's dive right in with international footballing news. And World Cup winner and legend winner Toni Kroos has confirmed his return to the German national team. That's ahead of their Euro 2024 campaign, which of course will be hosted in Germany. The 34-year-old midfielder who retired from Euro 2020 or shortly after will be available for selection in upcoming friendlies up against France and the Netherlands. Great preparation. Germany aims to improve its performance, obviously, following recent struggles, including early exits in the past two World Cups, most recently in Qatar. Then, staying with footballing news, this time off the pitch, Spanish head coach Luis de la Fuente has now signed a contract extension up until 2026, ensuring his leadership through the next World Cup in the United States, Mexico and Canada. So the Spanish Football Federation stated that this extension provides stability ahead of the European Championships in June. And de la Fuente, he took over as coach back in 2022 following Spain's early exit from that World Cup in Qatar as well. Now let's look at some action currently or about to play out in cricket. And fast bowler Ollie Robinson, he's got the call up. He's been included in the English team for the fourth test against India in Ranchi, marking his first match of the series. The 30-year-old's last appearance, in fact, for England was back in the Ashes test, in that third Ashes test at Headingley last year. He now replaces Mark Wood, while spinner Shoaib Bashir replaces Rehan Ahmed. So after a 434-run demolishing in that third test, England need to bounce back. They currently trail 2-1 in the five-match series. And now finally, rounding off with golf, oh, not the best day out for Charlie Woods, the 15-year-old son of Tiger Woods. He sadly saw his hopes of qualifying for the PGA Tour event in Palm Beach Gardens dashed after shooting a 16-over par 86 in a pre-qualifying event. Wouldn't have beaten Sean on a good day. So despite aspirations to make it to the US PGA Tour, the Cognizant Classic is around at Lost Lake Golf Club, ending any chance of a tour debut at this stage, I will say. Well, Woods showed some promise early on. A rough patch at the par 4 seventh hole hindered his progress. So despite the setback, Woods, he maintained his composure. He showed some real class. And of course, he's previously showcased his talent alongside his father in exhibition tournaments. It's not going to be long before this young man makes it onto the tour, I have no doubt. But that's where we leave our sporting highlights, albeit we will be sitting down with Billy LaRue in just a moment to delve a little bit deeper into his rugby aspirations for the season ahead. But right now, let's deal with your aspirations in the traffic and get the latest on the roads.
We start with traffic in Midrand, Johannesburg. There's some congestion on the N1 northbound. It's before Winnie Mandela Drive, and the back of queue is at Malebongwe Drive. Expect delays. In Pinetown, Durban, there's major backlog on the N3 highway towards Marion Hill Plaza. Approach with caution due to an offline system and add additional travel time to your journey. And in Mitchell's Plain, Cape Town, there are road closures on the R300 highway due to violent protesting in the Mitchell's Plain area. Please avoid the affected areas and make use of an alternative route. That's your traffic. Let's take a final look at your weather. And the SA Weather Service has issued a warning for severe thunderstorms in different parts of KwaZulu-Natal for today. This will affect the western parts of the province, including Uthekela, Amajuba, Harigwala and Umzinyathi. Forecaster Ayanda Ntele says residents can also expect heavy rains, damaging winds and lightning. Meanwhile, the city of Tshwane has commended the bravery and resilience shown by emergency personnel when they responded to a severe thunderstorm that hit the capital city earlier this week. Two people were killed by lightning and two others hospitalized in Olifantshoek in Centurion. Other areas affected by the storm include Cullinan, Rafilwe and Hammanskraal. Tshwane Community Safety MMC Grandi Tienison said the city reaffirms its commitment to prioritising the safety and well-being of all residents. We're going to finish the morning off by taking a final look at your sunrise view. Edina from Vierfontein shared our final sunrise view for today. What a gorgeous sunrise view, and look at the cloud formations in the sky. Well, if you would love to share your morning view, do so on our WhatsApp line. It's 063-408-8863. Here's a final look at your temperatures across the country.
out as it is today could be your best day yet. Set your sights on winning the millions when you play Powerball and Powerball Plus. Oh, forget the 66 million rand in total estimated jackpots today. That is a lot. Just imagine the endless possibilities. So you can play Powerball for an estimated 40 million rand and Powerball Plus for an estimated 26 million rand. But there is only one way, of course, of standing a chance of winning the millions, and that's if you play. So please get your ticket, and this is how you can do it. You can go in-store pretty much anywhere. You can go onto online, onto nationallottery.co.za. That's their website. Use their mobile app. You can use your own cell phone banking app, or you can simply dial *120*7529# for USSD. And we've got all of those details up on our social pages, so please check them out. And let us know what you would spend that money on. A life-changing 66 million rand in total estimated Powerball and Powerball Plus jackpots are waiting to be won. Why should it not be won by you? But you gotta ponder, pusher, play. Oh, well, talking of winners, some big winners in the cinema world, and we're gonna head to Tinseltown in just a moment with JP Sebastian to do a bit of an award season stock take, if you will. And then, of course, we're gonna sit down with Holly and Valida Roo one more time to find out about their future plans, a little bit of rugby, a little bit of life, a little bit of family. What's on the cards for a golden couple in South African rugby? We cannot wait for that chat. Stick around. Welcome back, you beauties. Yes, we have been buzzing this morning. Why? Because we are spending the morning with newlyweds. If it sounds good to us, I'm sure they love the sound of that. Valida Roo and Holly LaRue from Valida's rugby endeavours to Holly's culinary pursuits. Join us as we uncover a little bit more about their dynamic journey and what lays ahead. Because you've got to think about these things when you form a family and you start that focus. Thank you so much for sticking around, guys. Really, really love having you here.
Oh, I feel like we need to... I don't want to say throw them in the deep end, but we did pose quite a few questions.
I think we've done that a few times, so maybe just follow on that course, yeah.
People to ask questions. And we actually got one on social media. So let's see what came through. Our first question came through from Rugzak that says, Vili has to be the most passionate Springbok of all time. He runs up after the Springboks wins a penalty. Can you ask him what he says to keep the guys pumped?
I love that.
Yeah, obviously that's in the moment thing, just passionate, like he says. I think we all are passionate. Even I'm passionate out the box playing for them. So, yeah, I just obviously run up and try to look for opportunity first of all, and then just congratulate the guy that did something, just encourage him, and then it's just next job mentality at the Springbok. So that's just the things that go through my head and that I just... contribute to the guys and shout from the back because I'm obviously at the back seeing everything, so I can just shout at them and it's mostly just next job mentality.
There is nothing more beautiful than seeing a fullback run up to pat a hooker or a prop on the bum for a scrum penalty. I'm sorry, that is the beauty of rugby right there because we understand what it matters, how much it matters. I'm going to say this to both of you because I don't know when next I'll get this chance, but thank you. Aww. Thank you for what you've done over this, not just the last kind of, you know, season of your life, but everything that you've devoted to this game. As someone, check now, the goosebumps are coming. But from someone who lives that with my six-year-old son who wakes up to watch these matches, to be there, it is awe-inspiring. Mm-hmm. Billy, maybe I can put it to you. How do you see that role? Because we love making you a statesman. We love making you the guy who's got to lead the country, but you've just got to go and play rugby. Yeah. How have you been able to kind of walk that path? Because you said it yourself. You're the guy who's just got to go in, fit in, make a plan, make it happen, often when the chips are down and it doesn't feel like we've got a plan to be made. How do you see your role in that team?
No, obviously I'm a bit on the older side currently, so there's a lot
he says with a sigh.
Yeah, there's it's at the World Cup. I was a 34-year-old running with 21-year-olds, so that's a 30.
I think Dion would have something to say. Eh?
Dion has got a few years on me, but he's not in the backs and has to sprint with a youngster. So it's a bit of a different ballgame there. So you're starting to know your body, you learn yourself, you know what works for your recovery wise. The most important thing is always to play on the weekend. Obviously, you have to put in the work during the week, which is important, but it's different for certain players and age-wise. And like I can say it like that, like a 21-year-old, they would do everything and run 120% everywhere. But the older guys born in the 80s, I would say, we're a bit more clever. We pace ourselves and we know on the weekend you've got a job to do. So that's the most important thing, is to go out there and then obviously do your job. And then just my role in the team is if I can guide where I can, help youngsters coming through, obviously that's nice, because I had that when I joined the Springboks. So I'm relishing that role, and I'll do my best to play as long as I can. I don't know how long that would still be, but for me, it's just about enjoying myself and, yeah, being out there.
We're not going to let you go, dude, so let's just get that straight. Yeah.
I mean, Holly, you are extremely dynamic. I mean, I enjoyed being in the kitchen with you, because you're a gut health specialist, yeah. And you love and understand, you know, how food and the body reacts. But how do you personally answer the hundreds of DMs that come through, yeah, between consultations and recipe development, and even just prioritizing your own personal interests? For how sure. do you manage to do it all?
Yeah, I think it's very important for me to answer everyone individually, because when I was going through gut health issues, I never had that person.
Okay.
So I think it's really important that people know that you have a safe space to for discuss sure. those things. Like, I won't get a million comments on a picture, but I get the inbox messages, because it's really private. Gut health stuff is a struggle and it's really private. So helping people, that's amazing for me. But balancing it is busy. It's really busy. I think we both are really supportive of each other's careers, and we try and sort of make time for both of them. I mean, when I was at chef school, we did 9 months long distance.
Sure.
So that was pretty intense. He was in Japan, so time zones, he was sleeping, I was awake. Mm. And we're both just very busy, but we are 100% supportive of each other's careers, so.
And that kind of, that's when you prove it. You get it done because you have to get it done. And then I think that's been the big shift for certainly me and my wife, is this kind of team mentality. Mm. It was a button was pushed that I was able to see maybe a longer arc than I have been able to in the past. And I'm sure for a rugby player, you don't see 20 years, 30 years. You're thinking about next season. Mm. You're thinking about the next team that you've got to slot into. And of course, you're slotting beautifully into a team right now. Did that conversation change when you set up to get in at the Bulls and kind of look at this next phase? Were you quite clear about, okay, this is what I need, this is what I want, this is where I'm going? Or how did that kind of relationship form?
Yeah, no, I'm just very fortunate that I got opportunity to come play back in South Africa, and the Bulls gave me that chance to come. And I can't thank them, the Bulls, Vodacom Bulls and Jake, enough for the opportunity they gave me. There's a lot of youngsters in the team as well, and a lot of exciting guys coming through and playing unbelievable rugby, and just to do my part and help where I can there, if I'm playing or if I'm on the bench or if I'm not even in the 23, but just helping preparing the team, because I think that's what people mostly forget, is the guys preparing the team that's playing on the weekend. They are just as important, because
for sure.
the pictures those guys paint for you during the week is, if you've seen it 50 times during the week, and then you see it on the field on the weekend, it's like you've seen this picture before. It's played over and over in
just
your
clicks.
Head.
Yeah.
Just clicks. So yeah, no, Yeah, I'm here and enjoying it, and obviously a big North-South derby next weekend at Loftus. So I think everyone is very excited for that game, and yes, we all are.
I'm just thinking about a URC final, but you think you're just going to chill this season. Dude, just strap yourself in, buddy. Just strap yourself in.
Oh, well, it's been amazing having you both here. Enjoy the honeymoon bubble. Enjoy this phase and all the exciting things that's to come. I know there's a lot of unknowns, and I think that's the exciting part, especially given that both of you are so ambitious and so supportive of one another's dreams and goals.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you for having us, guys.
Yes.
Oh. Love you guys. Man, the joy of our job. And I think for me, why it is so vital that we do express gratitude, because you've been in that front row with us as we watched this journey play out. You can hear the trumpets or vuvuzelas are already calling out to the skies. But what an absolute gem to have these two in studio this morning. So keep the questions coming. Keep the love pouring out. They do answer DMs. We have proven that in both cases, but an absolutely wonderful opportunity. And of course, the show ain't done and dusted yet. We are still going to have some fun.
Definitely. JP Sebastian, he is around and he's going to talk all things BAFTAs. And then G-Man is going to get his rhythm on.
And they had to bring in...
going to do some gumboot dance.
Some really young, agile, flexible young guys who look ready to put on a show. We're going to have some fun after this and hopefully find some rhythm. Hopefully.
It's my feel-good breakfast show. Welcome back. We have JP Sebastian here with us on your feel-good breakfast show, Espresso on S3. And we're about to talk movies, but not just movies. Movie awards, because it's that season. There's more awards than just the Oscars.
Thank you, ma'am. Yes.
And there's more awards than just the other one, the Emmys.
Yeah, and the BAFTAs and the SAGs. And those are obviously the heavyweights. But, man, they're like... whole guilds of experts who we just like gloss over because they don't get the airtime or something like
they
that.
They don't speak to the celebrity culture possibly.
Yeah, and there are people behind the camera, like poor cameraman Rudy over there, who's nodding sadly that he doesn't get the acclaim necessarily these faces. And he's beautiful, trust me. No, he's not.
He is lovely.
I love you, Rudy.
So maybe let's start with the BAFTAs, because that is a heavy hitter.
Yeah, and surprise, surprise, I'm sure that you would know some of these names. So the holdovers is on the left there, and took for Divine Joy Randolph. She probably definitely will get the supporting role at Oscar. Aside from that, there were Poor Things and another one. But the main one that was on everyone's watch list, obviously with 13 nominations, was Oppenheimer. And swept 7 of those awards. Sure. So Oscar voting is happening until the 27th of February. And this probably pretty much cements it. Because now, you know, like, people from the Academy, voters, which include actors, which include directors, which include everyone else, are going, yeah, that's made up my mind for me. You know, if I was teetering on the edge of whether I give it to Cillian Murphy or whether I give it to someone else.
It's its moment. Yeah. This is their
I wonder, though, like, if some people don't go, okay, well, they've had a lot of joy from the BAFTAs, maybe let's spread the playing field. I might vote like that person.
But, the underdog, always the underdog,
But for sure, Oppenheimer definitely deserves, and you it got cinematography, Hoyt van Hoytema, it got score, it got editing, it got best director, obviously Christopher Nolan, best picture, and Cillian Murphy, and also Robert Downey Jr. for supporting actor, so cleaned up pretty good.
Wow.
So there's your cue, Zoe, you need to see it. We were speaking about that yesterday. It is very good.
Like, yes.
As a biopic, usually biopics are quite droog, you know, but like...
Yeah. This is a good one.
This is a visual feast.
Okay, I'll have to make that my mission to see it before the Oscars.
Let's
move over to what I would assume is another heavy hitter, because it's the 51st, Annie Awards?
Yes, the Annie's, man, animation doesn't get the credit it deserves. And so there's like goofy rules, rules at the Oscars, where other categories, editors will vote for editors. Cinematographers will vote for cinematographers. But in animation, you as a guild, as an Academy member can go, oh, I feel like voting for animation. So this is how like stuff like Disney's Elemental sneaks in. And Disney's Elemental, well, Pixar's Elemental is just not up to scratch compared
to the Oscars. That's not Academy Award
so
winning.
For this reason, you get stuff like Spider-Man Across the Spider-Verse that cleaned up.
Yes, sir.
Those other names, by the way, that you would have seen there was The Boy and the Heron, Nimona, and I can't remember the other one. But whatever, it's Spider-Man that took the cake. And that was 7 wins off 7 nominations,
yes.
Because good grief, Spider-Man is an achievement.
7 out of 7.
So it was, I said this before in my review already, but it was 1,000 animators working in concert all over the world, 24/7. It's the largest animation project in history. And really what Spider-Verse did, even with the first one, is break the corporate mold even, because you had a lot of suits and you had a lot of executives going, achieve the Pixar look, get your thing to look like Pixar, and we're good. We're, you know,
as
we're
long
shareholders
as tons of kids are going to watch it, great.
But they took so many risks. If you look at these sort of like animation styles, that within the program, you get a lot of computer programs that's similar to say autocorrect or spell checker will try and hold your hand through the process. But they purposely had to break their programs to go, no, I know how real life light works. I don't want real life light. So they purposely broke their programs to achieve these kind of looks, and for that reason, a lot of animations are saying, why can't we push it to the next level, like Spider-Man Across the
Spider-Man. And I'm thinking, because the first was so amazing, you could have 1,000 animators working on the second, knowing exactly where they're going, because
we'll
it set that tone.
Wait for 2025 for the third.
Okay, let's take a slight short left here. The 5th Society of Composers and Lyricists Awards. I can understand why not everyone's talking about this particular award group, because no one can say it.
But I mean, like, it's half of what makes movies is the score.
Exactly.
The sound. You should be able to turn off all dialogue and the movie should still make sense.
Yeah, for sure.
So this is also a union that represents these artists, including, and some of the other nominees and winners were, if our director can show the pick, it was Billie Eilish for Bobby. Olivia Rodrigo also won for it. So those are original songs. That was Hunger Games. And then in the middle was the Michael J. Fox documentary, which won for independent film. But for major studio film was Ludwig Göransson, who won for Oppenheimer. Surprise, surprise, I suppose. You know, we were just marking the cleanup, but a major surprise there is you expect composers to be old, right? Like, all their photos should be in black and white. Like, Hans Zimmer is...
You have no right to be that good.
You should have sculptures of yourself in your house. But Ludwig Göransson is 39. He's filling the shoes of Hans Zimmer for Christopher Nolan, who's 66. Joe Hisaishi is 73. of Boy and the Heron. And then, who sadly passed away last year, 80, is Robbie Robertson for Killers of the Flower Moon. So this 39-year-old comes along. He's already won an Oscar for Black Panther, if I recall correctly, and he will win the Oscar for Oppenheimer. But the stuff that they did here was ridiculous. So imagine yourself, you, me, and Graham are jogging. And our director tells us, okay, and change speed 20%, and change speed another 20%. Like, it's now playing music. One of the biggest parts of that was the violin pieces, and they had to tell 26 violinists, okay, 20% false, 20%. Oh, so watch behind these things for yourself. Jake's not a musical, he can't explain it, but he's got to move on. So next awards, please.
Very exciting. So, fourth Set Decorators Society and America Awards. That, you see, I didn't even know these awards existed.
And they're a bunch of professionals, but one of our professionals, unfortunately, is telling us that I've eaten through my time. And you know what? Do yourself a favor and learn about some of these people, like the set decorators of the world. Like, we were also going to talk about makeup artists, visual effects, obviously, is a big deal. Costumes, which actors say is half of their job done.
Yeah.
If you got me dressed for the role, I'm in the space.
Yeah, and when it comes to prosthetics and things like that, it's an entirely different level. JP Sebastian, thank you for doing a deep dive. I love the fact that you can start to kind of work out where that Oscar glory is going to end up with all of the awards that have come this far. But hey, it is a massive award season with some heavy hitters in the world of cinema, which makes me excited. But right now, some heavy hitters waiting for us up in Jersey.
You're on your Feel Good Breakfast show, which means that we are still working on this thing of making sure that come 9 a.m. you are indeed feeling good. And thus, my friend, I remind you of the fact that the holidays, they're gone. And this means we are deep within our work here. But that also reminds me that, listen, you've been working hard. And at any point, you deserve to have a bit of a pamper day, a spa day, even if you will. And that is why this morning we are talking all about the luxurious, delicious lotions for your body that you deserve to have, along with the delightful diffusers that your home deserves to have. And I present to you something I absolutely love. It is the Molton Brown sustainable beauty brand that we all deserve to have in our homes. And this morning, we are joined by senior brand manager Coco Nyumbu of beautiful Molton Brown, all in the name of getting you that pamper day that you deserve. Hello, my Coco.
Hello, Zanele.
How are you?
I'm wonderful. Thank you very much.
That's good. I mean, girl, you have made this place smell absolutely wonderful. I feel like this is a spa day for me already.
Right?
Yeah.
We've created the ambience.
Yeah.
Right? So I'm really excited to have this opportunity, Zanele, to kind of take you through this amazing, amazing brand.
Yes.
And you rightfully described it.
Mm-hmm.
So for this pamper session that we have, I just want you to relax. I want to transport you into this beautiful place where you experience luxury and you just relax.
Okay, I'm ready.
To start us off, what I brought with me here is one of my favorite fragrances, right?
Mm-hmm.
It's the Recharge Black Pepper. It's woody, it's iconic, it has a kick of citrus.
Uh-huh.
And I'm just gonna spray that in the room.
Okay. Mm-hmm. I can already smell that.
It's lovely, isn't it?
I can already smell it.
And that is a great way to start your pamper session.
Mm-hmm.
I've made sure to ensure that you are completely relaxed. I've lit our candle.
Yes.
And that's delivering a very uplifting aroma, which you picked up immediately.
I said I was more relaxed already when you got here.
And that's exactly what the products are.
Yeah.
So when you make your choice before your session, we have two options of fragrances. In Molton Brown, we have the EDP, which is a concentrated fragrance, and we have an EDT, which is a lighter fragrance. So it's entirely up to you what you prefer.
And what you just feel.
Amazing.
Yay.
Amazing and relaxed.
Mm.
And before every pamper session, we know what is absolutely important is a thoroughly cleansed body.
Okay.
And this product here is one of the cult favorites of South Africa.
Mm.
Zanele, you're gonna love this. It has 24 karat gold speckles.
It I can see
it. Smells
that.
Divine. I want you to smell it quickly.
I wanna eat it. It's so good.
It takes
smells.
You somewhere, right?
Yes.
It takes you somewhere.
Oh, that smells delicious.
It does. So
yes.
We make sure that you thoroughly cleanse your body. And I would always recommend, like I said, this is a South African icon. It's a cult favorite of South Africa.
Yes.
And it's essentially, and imagine it like this.
Mm.
It's a sophisticated gift for your body
mm-hmm.
and your bathroom.
I love that.
How's about that?
Yes.
So once you're thoroughly cleansed, the next step is to move into body lotions.
Mm-hmm.
We have options of the body lotions or the hand lotions, as well as the washes. They're available in both body and hand.
Yes.
And this is a similar fragrance to this, which is the Oud Accord, and I've already mentioned that it's a cult favorite. Mm. So Nelly, I've got to dab a little bit on
this. Please, my hands really are even dry actually at the moment. So thank you so much, my beautiful.
Now quickly massage it.
Oh, you are so Coco. Do you want to come here every day?
Of course.
You're welcome. Thank you.
Of course, honey. We love doing this. Just making sure that it's nicely moisturized your palm.
Yeah.
And not forgetting your beautiful cuticles.
Okay.
And I just do that. And I want you to quickly smell it.
Oh, I'm ready.
And allow the fragrance to envelope you. It's really absolutely divine.
Okay, I'm ready. Mm-hmm. Oh my goodness. It really smells like luxury.
Smell like luxury.
Oh.
And that is the point of the brand.
Yeah.
Molton Brown is about delivering those products that make you feel good.
Yeah.
So if you want an ultimately nourished and just divinely smooth skin, you also have the option of our body oils.
Yes.
And I've also selected the same, which is part of the Oud Accord family. Mm. So if you're that person that really prefers intense moisturization and you leave your skin very silky and radiant.
I'm that person.
You are that girl, right? Uh-huh. We love that. There's nothing, it's not complete without a body oil,
yes,
isn't it?
Yes, exactly.
So this is the Oud Accord body oil that also comes in to support the range. So
I love
really,
that.
Really. And after your entire pampering session, you've received your massage, the products have been applied.
Yes.
I would always recommend that we finish off with a spritz of fragrance on your body. You know why?
Yes.
There's power in layering. So can I quickly spritz
Of course. Yes, please. Oh, so once you've done all of this and you already smell so good, then you now add a Molton Brown fragrance.
Because the layering just brings the entire... It completes the whole experience.
I love that. And this is what I was actually going to ask you as well, because we know that Molton Brown is the ultimate spa day just partner to go along with you and having this delicious thing.
Yes.
And I want to know, you know, what can we do to 100% make sure that our spa day is complete?
I would always say that from the start to finish, have all your complete products as I've shown you here, and make sure that as well, besides just the candle, you have the option of your home fragrances, like your aroma reeds, or diffusers, as a lot of people like to call them.
Yes.
So that will complete the entire experience for you.
I love it. Oh, this place smells amazing. I need all of this in my home. Everything must be in my home.
I agree.
One last thing I want to ask is, because of course you guys, you and Woolies coming together, it's because of how you believe in sustainability. So tell me, why else is it that Woolies and Molton Brown came together?
It's a fabulous question. So I think at the heart of the brands, it's about people.
Yeah.
Right. Woolworths is about people. Both brands, from a Woolworths and a Molton Brown perspective, at the heart of who they are and why they do what they do, it's about people. It's about customers.
Come on.
So from a Woolworths environment, it's creating those environments and bringing those ultra luxury brands like Molton Brown, because we know it's found in the environment, into South African retail spaces. And Molton Brown itself, the passion for people, the customers, in developing products that are expertly crafted to deliver luxury.
Oh.
That's one. The second thing is, we know Woolworths has a strong heritage of quality. It's a loved South African brand that's been built on years of quality. And undoubtedly, they're number one. We trust them.
100%
trust them for quality.
And this is quality.
This is quality.
I love it.
That is the similarity. The brand was started in 1971.
Yes.
It's made in England. And Zanele, the made in England is not just. It's to ensure that they control quality from start to finish.
I love
like
it.
Words.
Coco, we appreciate you. And thank you so much. I'm smelling amazing. I can go and just live my life now being luxurious. And this is the thing. We want you to be luxurious, my love. The ultimate beauty brand. And Molton Brown is giving away something just for you indeed. We have got two beautiful pamper kits that could be coming to you, but the thing is that you have to enter. It is the competition that you deserve, and all you got to do is head over to our pages as Espresso, whether it's Facebook, X, or Instagram. Look for the Molton Brown post, and the Woolies post rather, and that is where you'll be able to find where you can put in your comment in the comment section and let us know what is your ultimate spa day product, the one that makes it that much more better and honestly just finishes it off so beautifully so that you can continue just going to live life after that spa day. Let us know in the comment section. Make sure you use hashtag Woolies X Molton Brown, and just like that, you're entered into the competition, my friend. And do not forget that it does close on the 25th of February, Sunday at midnight, and I don't want you to miss out, so go do it now. All the T's and C's you need, they are on expressoshow.com, and all the best, because you deserve a pampered day. And like I said, those delightful delightful diffusers and as well as the luxury body lotions that you need to make sure that your day indeed gets started off so perfectly, or your pamper day even goes beautifully. It is what you need in terms of this divine collaboration with Molton Brown and Woolworths. Right about now, I need you to stick around because the Cape Town family has a whole lot more coming up for us between now and 9 o'clock.
Yes, I'm going to stress the word family. Thank you so much for that one, Zanella. The superstars have arrived, proudly representing the Imibala Trust and their mentor, Joshua. These kids are going to put us through our paces in just a moment. In fact, Joshua, can you give us a little taste?
Go.
Aina, indeed.
It's my feel-good breakfast show.
Ah, welcome back. I am terrified, and with good reason. For years, we've had different dance genres coming through this amazing espresso studio space, and one that always amazes us. The footwork, the hand coordination is gumboot dancing. The spirit and energy is amazing. And here to show us a little of what it takes is Joshua Mralasi, the head lead teacher of dance, drama and music of the incredible Imibala Trust. And he's brought his young warriors with him who are going to put me through my paces in just a moment. And yes, give us an amazing Friday dance a little bit later. So Joshua, thank you so much.
Thank you for having us. Yeah.
And thank you for doing what you do, because this is an amazing plug-in. If you can get young men at this age and give them the tools, magic starts to happen.
Indeed, it has already started.
You can see it, you can feel it, buddy. What is it about gumboot dancing, though? This particular genre of dance, which stands in its own right, what is it about this that makes it so magical, do you think?
So, obviously, it's originated in our country. So
it's exactly ours.
Yeah. So, and then there's that, and then there's the basic idea that we get to express the rhythm with our own bodies. So that actually helps us basically connect with ourselves more, connect with the rhythm more, because everyone says they don't have rhythm, right? I don't think so. I think if you have a heartbeat, you can basically...
Just stick around, buddy. Let's wait and see.
Are you going to surprise me now?
I might just change your mind.
Yeah. Yeah, so in general, it really is just a connection with your body and with the rhythm, and also in a group. It's rare that you see someone perform a gumboot dance solo. Yeah. It always has like a group performing,
And there's magic in that as well.
Yeah.
What is it about the collaborative energy of the space? What do you see happening to the youngsters that come through your system that get connected to this kind of energy?
So initially when we created this dance, it was meant to be an exercise. So in you know, in ballet, there's like the bar work and the center work.
Yeah, for sure.
So that's what I intended. It was the idea of creating an exercise. Think of it as a learning the dictionary.
Yeah.
And then they kind of turned it into a dance. Basically, they took the words that I taught, and then it basically became like a poem, essentially, as it is.
How cool
and
is that?
The thing is, the energy between all of them kind of keeps going up and up and up and up. Because when they started, it was pretty like shy. I don't know. You know. And then as they practiced and they worked hard at it, harder than I even encouraged and expected, it's been.
They embraced it.
Yeah,
they absolutely embraced it. I'm ready to embrace all of you and
awesome.
Hopefully some sense of rhythm. I'm going to put this down.
Oh, is it? Okay.
Right.
Okay.
Okay, so let's give me the basics.
The basics.
Help me find my feet in this incredible genre of dance.
So I know that you've probably been exposed to some piano and quieter, right? Very light on the feet, but this one is a bit more grounded. So we're going to start with the basic, call this neutral position in
neutral.
Drama. So you've got the feet together, toes out, heels out. There we go. So that's your neutral position. You can bend your knees a bit more grounded.
Okay.
So think of slapping on the sides of your calves. Right, great. So
cool.
Now we're going to teach you the one that you just saw now.
Oh, and I will get an A-nar.
Yeah.
I guarantee you there will be an A-nar.
It's a bit of a rhythmic Sally or Simon Says, right?
Okay, cool.
So we're going to go step, out, in, step, in, clap.
Okay, in, clap.
Yes, let's go again.
Okay.
And step, out, in, step, in, clap. You see?
Okay.
See, so we're all gonna go in.
Because that's
see?
Really slow.
So. Yeah. So we're gonna go in. So after the step clap, we're gonna go step clap again.
Okay.
So we're gonna go step out in, step in, clap, step, clap. Yes.
Okay.
Okay. So we're gonna go step out in, step
whoop.
In, clap, step, clap, step out in, step, step. And then this is a bit of a flavor from them. And then you're gonna put your hands here.
Okay.
Yes.
Do I have to make that?
That's the one. Yes.
Okay.
Yeah. So let's take it again slowly.
Ooh, okay. Yes.
And there we go.
Step
out in. Step in. Clap. Step clap. Step out in. Step step. Yes. Very nice. You got it. So you don't have a little rhythm as you said. I'm actually surprised, not surprised.
Yeah, exactly.
Very nice. Awesome.
There are a lot of people surprised, but just wait.
No, that
just
was really
wait.
Good. Was
okay,
good.
I like that.
Yeah.
I love how grounded you get in your body. Can we do that with a little bit of music, please? Just a little bit of flavor.
Well, this is the rhythm essentially. So
I love
we
kind
of yeah. So we are it.
I need your energy. Let's go.
Okay. Okay, boys. Let's start it from Die Mesquite. So they're gonna sound. Is it again? Die Mesquite het my gebyt. Listen, I don't write.
I was there last night.
Yeah,
I was there last night. Check.
Yes, great. So boys from Mesquite, slowly.
Die Mesquite het my gebyt.
Okay, I was about 5 seconds behind.
No, but that was not bad
absolutely
at all.
Amazing.
Yeah,
no, you guys awesome. Are phenomenal.
Yes.
What I love the most is the eyes, the energy and joy that I'm seeing right now. Mm. You want to see these young men in full flight.
Yeah.
The Emmy Barlow Trust are doing amazing work. What these youngsters are doing, even better because they're doing it for themselves. And you'll get a taste after this.
Oh, well, after all that hard work, I think you deserve a naughty treat. In fact, all of you, because this next recipe is the epitome of indulgence. These molten salted caramel brownies are the perfect blend of the richness and fudginess with a salted caramel center, promising oozing satisfaction. Now, Holly is still with us here today, and we're very excited that I now get to teach her a naughty recipe. So I know you're more on, you're more on the healthy side. I'm gonna just show you the little bit more of the indulgent side. But do you have much of a sweet tooth?
I must say, caramel is definitely my weakness.
Okay.
Billy and I are big fans of chocolate when it's got caramel inside it. We don't have it often, but if we want a little sweet treat, it's got to have caramel in it.
There always has to be a bit of caramel.
Yeah.
So what we've done is we've melted some caramel and put a bit of molten salt in there, popped it in the freezer, and that's going to be incorporated into our brownie mix. Now, Holly, I'm going to ask you, if you don't mind, I'll do the whisking if you can break an egg in here.
Okay.
Because what we've got is we've already got melted butter and chocolate.
Yes.
We're going to add our egg. Eggs slowly along with some sugar with some whisking. So this is some serious multitasking. And this will definitely work up some arm strength. Is baking sweet treats something you do often, or do you prefer to stick to the savory dishes?
So the thing with anything gut health related, you have to know how to cook the original first.
Okay.
So you have to start with making brownies and taste it and say, okay, this tastes lekker, and then say, how can I remake this? And then you do your recipe testing over and over again with healthy products. I must say there's a lot of like chickpea brownies I've made that are not lekker. It's like, this is not the same. But you have to recipe test and try it out, and sometimes you win and often you don't win. So yeah.
Because often, you know, when something is, for example, gluten-free, it's notorious for not having a great texture.
Or that
great
like moisture, that like really nice moisture. It's often like dry and crumbly, or it just doesn't taste great. So
what are some trigger foods that some people that perhaps suspect they might have, you know, intolerances, or are there tests they should go and do?
So I work with a company called Viome who does gut health intelligence testing through your microbiome.
Okay.
And it's done through a stool sample, and you send it off to the labs in America, and then it comes back with like really specific, down to like if you should avoid oranges or apples, and it'll say specifically how much of it you should eat as well.
Okay.
So I don't work on a calorie counting sort of lifestyle. I don't believe in it. I believe in like eating intuitively and like reading your body. We are amazing healers. Our bodies are amazing healers. So I think you should really listen to your body and see, okay, if I'm not feeling that, then maybe it's not good for me.
And also question these things. Because so often people think it's normal to feel this way, and we're making a mess here in the kitchen, but I'm getting
my
in
OCD
there.
Anxiety.
I'm so sorry. I've added the vanilla essence. I'm adding the cocoa. We're about to add flour and chocolate nibs. So why don't we add that? I think I'll keep mixing.
I think we can fold it in.
So let's fold that
let's
in.
Let's use that one.
Sorry, this is a mess. This
That's
is
right.
this is what
great.
Happens
We're
when you put
great.
Me in the kitchen.
Yes. Okay.
Go for it. So we're gonna fold this in.
So
and add a little bit of salt.
So you're adding air is what you're doing when you're folding.
Okay.
Yeah. So you're making sure it's like nice and fluffy.
Okay. See, I'm learning something new today. I am loving this. Any dreams or aspirations to perhaps bring out a cookbook?
Absolutely. Actually, it's a project for this year.
Okay.
It's been requested for so many years, but I think we're going to look at doing an ebook. I like love recipe books, but you're not going to be in the middle of Woolies with your recipe book like going down the aisle. So
True.
It's quite nice to whip something up on your phone and scroll through it and say, okay, I can't say I've got a nut allergy. Say nut allergy recipes. Okay, cool, let's make this. These are the ingredients I need. So we try and make it like as consumer friendly as possible.
And that will also give you a lot of flexibility.
Yes, absolutely.
If you go traveling or whatever, wherever you end up.
Exactly.
Oh,
exactly.
I love that. So we've got our brownie batter done. I'm going to scoop about half of this into our tray. And then if you can do us the honors of putting that beautiful slab of caramel with malted salt on. And then we'll get the boys in to come and give this a bit of a taste. Does Vili have a sweet tooth?
Absolutely.
Okay.
Absolutely. 100%. So he'll love these.
Oh, love fantastic. It. You can place that in for us.
Good.
Obviously, the batter will melt and it will spread out.
Okay.
But the whole idea is just to put that delicious salty caramel in the middle.
Ooh, nice.
And that will all spread as the batter gets pushed around. I think, G-Man, do you and Vili want to join us here in the kitchen? Because we've just made the ultimate brownie recipe and our kitchen fairies have ready-made ones over there.
Music to our ears.
Yeah.
There we go. That will obviously go into the oven and Bob's
I've got, has she eaten any of the dough yet?
No, surprisingly
she's,
not.
Yeah, she's
not even
an
a lick
infamous
of the finger
dough
or...
eater.
Sure.
Okay, Vili, you gotta do the official taste test, my friend.
And you can be 100% honest because there's a lot of chocolate in there, but hopefully you get the hint of the salted caramel coming through in the middle.
Vili, you strike me as the kind of guy who can't not be 100%
Thank
honest,
you.
To be honest myself. Thank you so much.
Oh.
What
do you like? Do you
delicious,
Have a nibble of yours.
Oh,
it's really nice.
You weren't kidding,
delicious.
There's like proper caramel in there.
Oh,
you have to be careful, it can break a tooth.
Oh, that's naughty.
Oh, very naughty, but so good. Gooey and delicious. Mm. I think we all have chocolate all over our mouth.
We didn't get the brief for a TV bite, I'm sorry. But with these, it's a little bit difficult. We're going to take a momentary break. Then the Imibala Trust, these young men, you need to see, feel their energy to truly understand just how special they are. We'll plug into that after this and this, maybe a few more of those.
It's my feel-good breakfast show.
I think we've all felt like winners today. So welcome back, winners. Let's see if we can seal that deal. And we want you to set your sights on winning the millions. When you play Powerball and Powerball Plus, forget the 66 million rand in total estimated jackpots today. Imagine the endless possibility. No, don't even go there. Don't even allow your mind to go there.
Well, you can play Powerball for an estimated 40 million rand and Powerball Plus for an estimated 26 million rand. But there's only one way of standing a chance to win the millions, and that is if you play. You need to play in order to win.
Yeah, and in order to play, you've got to buy a ticket. That's really simple. You can get them in store on nationallottery.co.za, their mobile app, your cell phone banking. We'll probably have a little drop down, or you can dial *120*7529# for all of the vital USSD.
Oh, well, we have all of those details also on Expresso's social media pages. So go and check them out and make sure you get your ticket. A life-changing 66 million rand is up for grabs, and that's the total estimates for Powerball and Powerball Plus jackpots. That is waiting to be won. So who will it be? It could be you if you panda, push, or play.
Right now we need to round off a show, a week like this, just the perfect Friday dance. And we've got the incredible Imibala Trust represented by some incredible young men. In fact, they are from the Terrio School, and I'm sure the whole school is watching right now and is so proud. Without further ado, it's time for the official Friday dance. Enjoy.
Jessa.
Jessa.
a bite.
Based in Somerset West, go and check them out, go and support them in whatever way you can. They're doing amazing things. Likewise, this amazing couple beside us, Willie, Holly, thank you so much for playing along. Thank you for just being so open with us. We absolutely love both. We cherish you, in fact, Willie. We cherish you guys. Thank you guys so much.
All the best for what the future holds. Please, when you bring out that cookbook, come and visit us again.
Well, I will.
We hope you have enjoyed today. We hope you've enjoyed this amazing week. Go out there and conquer, and most importantly, stay safe. Don't forget how much we love you. We'll see you on Monday morning. Have an amazing weekend. Adios.
Bye.
Well done, everybody.
Say goodbye to nausea and cramps and say hello to delicious freedom with Nolax range of lactose-free milk and yogurt. Be free with lactose-free.
Another feel-good production.